It's time for Carthage football here on your sports beat station, KGAS. Tonight, the Bulldogs are in Liberty-Eylau in a matchup of two of the highly ranked teams in Class 4A. Carthage began the season last week in Gladewater with a no contest thanks to a power outage, and the Liberty-Eylau Leopards took a 61-55 loss to Gilmer. Tonight's game is brought to you in part by Carthage Flower Shop, Copper Falls, Denny's, Garrett Trekker Service, Bauer Furniture, the Bulldog Stop, First United Methodist Church of Carthage, Kelly's Carthage Collision, your local Sonic, Dustin Burns Real Estate, Courtney Construction, Fidelity Communication, Popcorn Place, Winkler House, Panola College, Panola National Bank, XL4, Carthage Furniture, First State Bank and Trust, Pippin Motor Company, Central Baptist Church of Carthage, the Hope Clinic of Tenahall, ETMC Carthage, Hudson Financial, the City of Carthage, Prosperity Bank, Pritchard & Abbott, Farmers State Bank, Texas Farm Bureau, Bagley Well Service, and Don Juan's. The KGAS crew is ready, but first, a word from Panola College.
When I picture my Panola, I picture opportunity, a chance to pursue a career as an electrician, one of the fastest growing occupations in the U.S. with the potential to earn nearly $70,000 a year. Panola's electrical program allows me to develop the skills needed through hands-on training in as little as 6 months. I'm excited to build a career with Panola College. What does Panola College look like for you? Picture your Panola. Visit panola.edu today.
And now live from Harrisfield in Texarkana, here's Larry Allen.
All right, thank you very much, Clay Allo. Indeed, we are coming to you live from Harrisfield, the home of the Liberty-Eylau Leopards, as the Leopards and the Bulldogs, two of the top-ranked Class 4A Division I teams in the state, get together here tonight at Harrisfield. Tonight's starting lineup is brought to you by Denny's. Denny's is a place for any meal at any time. That's right, come in anytime, because America's Diner is always open. Now here is tonight's starting lineup, and we're going to start with the offense for the Carthage Bulldogs. At center is Peyton Bickham, 6 foot, 225-pound senior. The right guard is Austin Gray, 5'10", 230-pound junior. At left guard is James Ebarb, 5'11", 250-pound senior. Left tackle, protecting the blind side of quarterback Kaysen Davis, is Tanner Elliott, 6'4", 275, a senior. And at right tackle is Jesse Pierce. Pierce, a 6'4", 180-pound junior. That offensive line, again, going from left to right, Elliott, Ebar, Bickham, Gray, and Pierce. A look at the Carthage backfield right after this from your Sports Beat station, KGAS.
If you need construction done, check with Carlos and Shane Courtney at Courtney Construction Incorporated. They're the best in the business, whether it's pipeline or dirt work or field maintenance or general construction. The Courtneys are well experienced. Give them a call today at 903-694-2911 or stop by 1300 Northeast Loop in Carthage. Courtney Construction Incorporated. When you need it done right, call Courtney Construction. They'll get it done.
Fidelity Communications is ready to turbocharge your internet service with this amazing offer. You can get 125 megabit internet with 6 months of free Wi-Fi for just $79.99 per month for the first year. New Fidelity Communications customers get special pricing on all three different internet packages, ranging from 25 to 125 megabits per second, starting as low as $24.99 per month. Call 1-800-392-8070 or visit us online at fidelitycommunications.com.
The ladies at the Popcorn Place are ready to take care of your floral needs. They offer cut flower arrangements, memorials, and potted plants. If there is a special occasion in the future, such as a birthday or anniversary, or maybe just a special arrangement, let the ladies at the Popcorn Place assist you with your selection. And don't forget that they carry some wonderful gift items like crystal and pottery, and have a bridal registry as well. This can all be found at the Popcorn Place on West Panola in Carthage, 903-693-5421.
All right, let's take a look now at the Carthage offense. We're coming to you live from Harrisfield in Texarkana, Texas. The Carthage Bulldogs and the Liberty-Eylau Leopards. Here's the Carthage backfield. Kaysen Davis, 6'2", 185-pound senior. He is the quarterback, and last week in that abbreviated game that was canceled up at Gladewater, he was 8 of 9 for 148 yards. At fullback will be Brewster Griffith. Griffith, 5'6", 170-pound senior. And the tailback is Keontae Ingram, 5'11", 200-pound junior. So it's Davis, Griffith, and Ingram, the Carthage backfield. We'll look at the wideouts and also the tight end right after this from KGAS, your sports beat station.
Well, I'm Frances Hopkins Frazier, and I decided to go to Winkler Place because I was falling, and I was calling my son to come help me. So, therefore, I prayed about it, and Winkler Place came into my mind. God gave me the answer. And I'm in Winkler Place now, and I enjoy living there. I have everything I need. I'm happy at Winkler Place.
When I picture Panola, I picture opportunity, a chance to pursue my dream of becoming a nurse, one of the fastest growing occupations in the U.S. with the potential to earn up to $82,000 a year. Panola's small class size allows me to receive personalized attention at a cost I can afford, and their state-of-the-art simulation labs allow me to develop excellent nursing skills. I'm excited to jumpstart my nursing career with Panola College. What does Panola College look like for you? Picture your Panola. Visit panola.edu today.
At Panola National Bank, we're constantly looking for ways to make community banking even better. Now we're making it easier for you to bank on the go with Mobile PNB. Our new mobile banking service allows you to access your accounts directly from your cell phone so you can make transfers, check balances, and search transactions all from the convenience of your cell phone or tablet. Be sure to check out our new free mobile apps in the iTunes Store and the Google Play Store. Panola National Bank, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
All right, we're going to look now at the wideouts for Carthage. That would include DeWaylon Ingram. He had a reception last week, 6 foot, 165-pound junior. The other one will be Rod Calloway, 6'3", 180-pound senior. We'll also see a lot of Mason Graham, a 6 foot, 200-pound senior. And the tight end for the Bulldogs, who had a couple of pass receptions last week, is Josh Gradberg. He also, one of those was a touchdown reception. Gradberg, 6'1", 180-pound senior. So the tight end is Gradberg, and the wideouts are going to be Calloway and Ingram. We'll be back to take a look at the Carthage defense right after this from KGAS.
This is Walter Sparks with XL Ford Lincoln Mercury here in Carthage, encouraging y'all to come out and see our large inventory of new cars, trucks, and SUVs. We have rebates up to $8,000 on selected models, a good selection of pre-owned cars and trucks at very affordable prices. Financing available with excellent service and parts. Check out our website, XL Ford of Carthage, for updates on a regular basis. Remember, we're still on the South Loop and we're still number one. God bless America and Semper Fi.
At Carthage Furniture, Monty Bacon and his staff have a deal for you. A sofa and love seat in dark brown or tan, your choice. Now add three tables and two beautiful lamps and it's yours for just $7.99. That's a sofa, love seat, three tables, two lamps, yours for $7.99. Or check this out, a red or brown love seat and sofa for $9.68. Speak Spanish? Monty can help. Carthage Furniture on West Panola in Carthage.
Here at First State Bank and Trust Company, we know that life can get busy. Since banking is a necessary part of life, but not always a productive use of your day, we're pleased to offer Mobile Deposit to make depositing checks faster and easier. Using an approved mobile device with internet access, Mobile Deposit allows you to snap a picture of the front and the back of your check, and then submit the check securely to your account, giving you more time to spend on the things that matter. Serving East Texas since 1902, First State Bank and Trust Company, Carthage.
Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
All right, one unusual thing about Harris Field, most football fields run north and south, but the sun is directly to our left. That means that this field runs east and west. And in most high school football stadiums, you put the visitors in the sun and the home crowd is in the shade. That happens over in Carthage at Bulldog Stadium. But here, a large building over on the far side shades the visitor side. So the Carthage fans are in the shade right now, and the Leopard faithful are right underneath us in the sun. Okay, let's take a look now at the defense for Carthage. And we're going to start with that defensive line, Trey Gatlin. The big guy, 6'6", 250 pounds, a senior. He's at strong end. The rush end is Montario Wilson, 5'9", 175 pounds. He's a senior. The two guys on the inside include Greg Hurst, 5'6", 180-pound senior, and Austin Russell, a 6'1", 230-pound senior. So if you're keeping track there of the numbers, four seniors on that defensive line for Carthage, Trey Gatlin, Austin Russell, Greg Hurst, and Montario Wilson. Look at the linebackers when we return here to Harris Field after right after this.
September is kicking off. We got up to 20% off on select GMC half-ton pickups 2016 models. We got up to 16% off on select 2016 Silverado models, not to mention 0% for 72 months on all 2016 Chevrolet models, excluding your base entry value packages. So come see us. We're Pippin Motor Company. We're located across from Panola College or on the web at pippinmotorcompany.com.
President Harry S. Truman once said, "If men and nations would but live by the precepts of the ancient prophets and the teachings of the Sermon on the Mount, problems which now seem so difficult would soon disappear." Hi, this is Dennis Smith, inviting you to come and worship with us, Central Baptist Church in Carthage. On Sunday, our services are at 9:30 a.m. and 10:45 a.m. If you can't come, tune us in on KGAS 103.7 FM or KGAS 1590 AM. We are also on Fidelity Cable Channel 18. May God bless you.
Panola County relies on ETMC Carthage for high-quality care from medical professionals you know and trust. We offer a full range of services, like 24-hour emergency and level 4 trauma care, diagnostics including 64-slice CT, MRI, digital mammography, bone density, ultrasound, and X-ray, and ETMC First Physicians Clinics with specialists in pediatrics and family health. ETMC is proud to be one with East Texas.
All right, we're going to look now at the linebackers for Carthage. In the middle is Mikael Gates, 6 foot, 225-pound junior. The soundbacker is Jose DeJulian. DeJulian is 5'9", 185, a junior. And the wheelbacker, who moved in from Beckville this year, is Jace Dixon. Dixon, a 5'11", 185-pound senior. So it's Gates in the middle, DeJulian, and Dixon round out the Carthage linebackers. A look at the secondary right after this from your Sports Beat Station in East Texas, KGAS.
The city of Carthage, county seat of Panola County, gas capital of the United States, and friendliest spot in the world. We have it all: temperate weather, lots of jobs, good schools and churches, and even the Texas Country Music Hall of Fame. Carthage, a great spot on Highway 59 to settle down or just to visit for a while. Panola College, local medical care, a low tax base, and great shopping. That's Carthage. Recommend us, refer us, and revive yourself in the piney woods of East Texas. Carthage, with places we're all proud to call home.
Are you experiencing sickness, fighting a toothache, or just need someone to vent your frustrations to? Stop by the Hope Project in downtown Tenahaw for all your medical, dental, and mental health needs. They accept Medicaid, Medicare, and most major insurance plans and offer a sliding fee discount for those who qualify. The Hope Project is now a designated site to offer counseling assistance with the healthcare marketplace. For a healthier East Texas, come see the Hope Project or call 936-248-HOPE.
Randy Hudson, a 1984 Carthage High School graduate, invites you to stop by their Carthage branch of the Hudson Financial Group. They offer property and casualty insurance on an individual platform, which allows them to help you with all types of risk with companies like the Hartford, Mass Mutual, and Travelers, to just name a few. Randy and his dad, Herb, look forward to assisting you with your insurance and financial needs. The Hudson Financial Group, 1507 West Panola in Carthage, 903-693-7874.
Our introduction of officials tonight is made possible by Carthage Flower Shop on the Square in downtown Carthage. Gifts, home seasonal arrangements, and memorials can be found at Carthage Flower Shop. The next time you need a special gift or memorial, call the Carthage Flower Shop at 903-693-3248. And now here are tonight's officials from the East Texas chapter. Wearing the white hat, the referee is Darren Lair. Lonnie Pinwell is the umpire. Justin Woodson, the head linesman. The line judge is Trey Portwood, and Lorito Guevara is the back judge. Again, the referee, Darren Lair. Here's a look at the Carthage secondary. Nick Moore is at one corner, 5'10", 160-pound senior. The other corner is Makai Colbert, 5'10", 185-pound junior. The free safety is another junior. That's 6'1", 170-pound Ashton Hicks. And the strong safety is 5'11", 185-pound senior Mason Graham. So again, that secondary, Moore and Colbert are the corners, the safeties Graham and Hicks. We return to Harris Field in Texarkana right after this from your Sports Beat Station, KGAS.
When you think of high school football in Texas, you think Carthage Bulldogs. When you think of banking, you should think Prosperity Bank. The Carthage Bulldogs have the strength, leadership, desire, and spirit to obtain another state championship. Prosperity Bank has those same attributes to serve your banking needs. We offer deposit accounts, debit cards, internet and mobile banking, mobile deposit, iPay, as well as consumer, commercial, and residential lending. We can service your needs wherever you are. Stop by the Carthage office and we will share with you our Bulldog spirit. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Pritchard & Abbott Incorporated are evaluating consultants. What does that mean? They appraise minerals, industrial, utility properties, and data services. From their evaluations of a net worth, fair taxes can be levied. Pritchard & Abbott Incorporated, doing their part to be a good neighbor and helping our part of the world stay strong and solvent. Pritchard & Abbott Incorporated, evaluating consultants.
We believe this is the first time that Carthage has been at Harris Field in Texarkana to play Liberty-Eylau since 1995, back when Dustin Burns was suiting up as a Carthage Bulldog. And if you're unfamiliar with where it is, when you come in on Highway 59, instead of taking the loop and going north toward I-30, you just go straight under the loop, and after about a quarter mile, turn to the right, and you're here at Harris Field. They have just completed the installation of brand new turf, and the turf looks great. They've got a black background in each end zone, and in the end zone to our right, we have Leopard spelled out in red, trimmed in white, and in the end zone to our left, Liberty-Eylau in red, trimmed in white. And they have one feature that I kind of like, and that is that each 5-yard line increment has alternating dark and light green. Also, a real bright LE in dark red in the middle of the field, trimmed in white. They have an eight-lane track surrounding the field. That sort of gives you a picture of where we are here tonight. We've got our full team here tonight. Dustin Burns is down on the sideline. Right now, Mark Harris.
Well, this is going to be a tough game tonight. This is a good bunch of kids. I played here in 1978, and that's when Coach Robertson, a bunch of us were coming off the field with cramps, and he said, it's General Hospital tonight, but it won't be next Friday night. And so we ran that next week and got in shape. But this football team we're playing tonight is really good. They're ranked for a reason. We've got to come with our A game to win. Liberty-Eylau won state in 2006 and 1999. Now, Larry, what do you remember about the state championship in 1999?
In 1999?
Uh-huh. You and I were in the Astrodome doing the ball game. For Legion Fields.
Oh, okay, all right.
And Liberty-Eylau won right we were setting up.
Okay, all right.
That's a long time ago, 1999. Yep. And we went on the next week to Texas Stadium, and Legion Fields was defeated by Salina at that point. But they have a couple of state championships themselves, and especially one in 2006, so they know how it is to win. They've had a pretty good ball program here for a long time. They've had some great athletes coming through here, and we're going to see some good ones tonight. So sit back, and if you didn't make it to the ball game, enjoy it. We're going to bring it to you the best we can. This is KGAS. We'll be back after this.
This is Mark Harris at Farmer State Bank in Carthage. Did you know Farmer State Bank offers 15, 20, and 30-year fixed-rate mortgages? We will service your loan in-house, and you can make a payment at one of our 5 full-service locations, Center, Main Bank, and Rough Rider Branch, Carthage, Joaquin, Shelbyville. So come by Farmer State Bank and let us help you buy the home of your dreams. Farmer State Bank, member FDIC, and equal housing lender. Money.
All right, we're back here at Harris Field, and one big announcement that we need to make. They have an athlete who is well-known. In fact, Scott Surratt, if you heard him in the interview this afternoon, the number 2 defensive end in the country, according to one ranking of recruits, and he is no longer on the team. Yes, LeGarian Carson, who is committed to the University of Texas, is no longer on the Liberty-Eylau football team. We do not know what caused his departure, but he will not be suiting up tonight.
Now, well,
we hate to hear that, don't we? Now, it doesn't mean that we're going to win the ball game, but he was a good one, 6'5", 255, and when he's playing well, Coach Surratt telling me there's absolutely no one on our team that could block him one-on-one. We were going to have to double-team him. but we don't have to worry about him tonight. All right, let's see. Dustin Burns, are you ready?
Yeah, sure am.
All right, take off.
I kind of agree with Mark. You know, this will be a good test for us after we weren't able to finish our game last week. Clear skies tonight. Sun's going down. It's not real hot. Seems to be not real humid as well. So this will be our first test since we weren't able to finish our scrimmage 2 weeks ago as well. Our stamina, how good a shape we're in. Liberty-Eylau looking at them as they're getting ready to run through their leopard blow up leopard over here. You know, they're tall, they got some big kids, they're athletic. I was talking to Coach Stacy, said they got a lot of athletes on the field that are very fast. And as you mentioned a while ago, last time we had Carthage had come here and play Liberty-Eylau, I asked Coach Stacy, we were talking about it. He also told me that he thought that in 2002 when Coach Safal was the coach, that they did a home and home just for 2 years. So it might have been 2002 or 2003. But I think the main thing for us is we're going to have to win that battle up front. We're going to need to get our run game established a little bit better than what we did against Laywater with their big guys up front. That way that we're not dictating whether or not we're going to pass the ball all the time. And, well, we're going to do a good job of controlling their run game. They did not pass the ball very well against Gilmer last week, and they had close to, I think, 350 yards rushing against Gilmer, so we're going to contain their two good backs and their quarterback as well.
Yes, their statistics last week, 385 yards rushing, 96 through the air, 481 total yards. But, of course, they gave up over 500 yards through the air to the Gilmer Buckeyes, who won that one 61-55. Okay, Carthage tonight is going to be in red pants. Remember, they were in all-white last week at Gladewater. Red pants, white jerseys, red numbers. They wear a red helmet. And the Leopards are in black pants, maroon jerseys, black numbers trimmed in white, and they wear black helmets. All right, the Bulldogs are lined up along the north sideline, and the Liberty-Eylau Leopards are going to line up along the south sideline for the national anthem, which will be coming up here in just a moment.
As soon as they get the flags up, they're just now putting them up.
All right. In addition to the new turf, they've also added some parking here, and I think some, as I understand it, some new restrooms over on the visitor side. They're beginning to make some improvements here at Harris Field. Now, this field it's been here a while. Did you say it was here when you played, Mark?
It was. It wasn't turf, but it was grass at that point. And we won that night 21-7. That was on our way to 11-1 season. Got beat in Mesquite that year after winning 11 straight.
All right, now looks like we are about ready for the national anthem. Okay, Liberty-Eylau Band's going to perform it. Let's see if we can pick it up. National anthem here at Harris Field.
In case you didn't know it, everybody was standing up.
Sir?
Everybody was standing up saluting the flag.
Yes, they were. That's right. All right, let's tell you that the coin toss is going to be presented by Copper Falls. Copper Falls in downtown Carthage is proud to bring you tonight's coin toss. Copper Falls buys gold and silver, plus Tommy specializes in custom jewelry design. Copper Falls on the square in downtown Carthage bringing you the coin toss. And we've got four captains coming out for the Bulldogs. Brewster Griffith is going to be one of them. Rod Calloway is another. Also Greg Hurst. And Kason Davis. And four captains are going to go out there for the Liberty-Eylau Leopards. Again, our officiating crew is an East Texas chapter. Darren Lair, the referee, Lonnie Pinwell, the umpire, head linesman, Justin Woodson. Trey Portwood is a line judge. Back judge is Larito Gravera. And, of course, if you've been listening to our broadcast or if you come to Bulldog games at Bulldog Stadium, you know that if Carthage gets the decision, Coach Surratt always takes the football, always. And incidentally, we're going to be at home next week against the White House Wildcats.
Have we had any word on when we're going to have chalk talk? Has that been talked about?
Yes, sir. I've got that answer for you.
Okay.
Okay, that is always the first Monday after Labor Day. So no chalk talk this coming Monday, Labor Day, but it'll be next week. All right. Carthage has won the toss, evidently. They have. And they're going to take the football, and they'll be defending the goal to our left, which is the goal to our west. Okay, the west goal line. Again, Copper Falls bringing you the coin toss. The first half kickoff is from Sonic. Wing night in America. Wing night in America at your Sonic in Carthage. Monday through Thursday after 5 p.m., wings are half price. Explore the six different flavors at Sonic in Carthage. Again, the first half kickoff brought to you by Sonic in Carthage. All right, the Bulldogs are going to be getting the football, and dropping back deep for the Bulldogs is going to be Makai Colbert, and that looks a little bit like Rod Calloway, and it is, and they'll be dropping back to about the 10-yard line. Incidentally, this field is lined for soccer, not only football. And again, this is the first game played on this AstroTurf. First time they've had turf here.
That's right.
This is, I'll tell you what, this is going to be a great test for the Bulldogs as far as where we stand, because Coach Surratt mentioning that this is one of the top teams in the state right here. And a team, wouldn't it be something if we met them in mid-December again over at AT&T Stadium for the state championship? Both teams in Division I. Liberty-Eylau in Region 2, Carthage in Region 3.
And you know this is going to be a good night, a good game tonight, Larry. You know why? It's on Harris Field.
Harris Field, that's
Harris
right.
Harris Field, that's what the deal is.
and that building across the way that says Harris Field, it also advertises the fact that, as Mark mentioned earlier, they've got two state championships, 1999 and 2006. All right, we're ready to get it underway. And here's the kick. It's going to be a high, short kick. Calloway comes up, takes it at the 16, to the 20, going left now, to the 25, to the 30, to the 35, 40. All right, he had a stiff arm of one of the Leopards at about the 25-yard line and winds up picking up about 15 yards after that. Great field position for Carthage.
Yeah, he just pushed the kid down. It was coming after him. Looked like a Earl Campbell stiff arm. Just pushed him away.
Carthage with the football. Ball is going to be on the left hash as Carthage goes from our left to right here at Harris Field.
Bowens is in the game.
And D. Bowens is in the ball game. Coach Surratt really iffy in the interview as to whether or not he was going to play. Trips to the right, twins to the left. Five wideouts for Carthage. Empty backfield. Davis with it. Looking right. He throws right. It's caught by Calloway at the 43 to the 45. Out of bounds at the 50-yard line. That's going to be a first down, 11 yards. That's a Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down.
Get your quarterback lubed up early. Get him a first completion under his belt. Make him comfortable about throwing the rest of the night.
Yeah, Calloway needs to tuck that ball. He had it hanging out there where he could have easily been knocked away and fumbled, but good pitch and catch there from Davis Calloway.
All right, the Bulldogs sending five wideouts on the first play from scrimmage, and this time we're going to have trips to the left. And this time we've got a tight end over on the right side. Now Brewster Griffith goes motion right. Handoff goes to Ingram. Ingram hitting the backfield and push back. That's going to be a loss on the play as they hand off to Keontae Ingram, and they swarm him for a loss of one back to the 50-yard line. It'll be second and 11.
Yeah, one of the things that we talked about on the way up here and that we need to control the line of scrimmage, and this bunch is going to be hard to control. Everybody's got to do their assignments like they should.
All right, this time Ingram goes wide to the left. We've got Bowens and Callaway split out to the right. Ingram, DeWaylen Ingram is split out to the left. Keontae Ingram in the backfield standing to the right of Kason Davis, who is in the shotgun. Second and 11 from midfield. Now Keontae Ingram goes motion left. Lines up as a receiver on the left side. So twins on each side now. Down to 2 seconds. 1 second on the play clock. Here's the snap, and the pass is caught on the right side by Bowens, and he is down quickly at the 45-yard line after a 5-yard gain, bringing up second and six. Make it third and six.
We were in a lineup, and I heard the coaches here next door yelling, "Nobody's over the tight end. Nobody's over the tight end." So we're throwing formations at them that they probably hadn't seen us do.
Yeah, they were double covering Roger Callaway, and we motioned Ingram out of the backfield, and the middle linebacker went with him, and I thought it would open up D. Bowens maybe coming with a route across the middle in single coverage.
All right, so now this time DeWaylen Ingram and D. Bowens go out to the left, and we've got split backs in the backfield behind Davis. Now Callaway goes motion left, swinging out to Callaway to the 45, trying to get the first down, and a great tackle there, a one-on-one tackle by one of the Leopards. Stops Callaway 4 yards short of the first down after a pickup of two.
Yeah, he got to the outside, threw a quick pass to him, and he went in motion and went up the sidelines about the numbers. And he got away with one. He juked one guy, but the other guy got his legs out from under him. We have a player on the field. This is KGS. We'll be back after this.
Oh, her first word.
Mama.
Then, before I knew it.
Mom!
Soccer practice, art club, driver's ed, dating, graduation, 5 years of college. Mom, this is Ted. Wedding bells and suddenly.
Grandma!
Life fast forwards. Keep up with Texas Farm Bureau Insurance and protection that changes with your auto, home, and life needs. It's the right coverage for any moment, because moments worth covering are never accidents.
For all your insurance needs, come see me, Jenny Morgan, at Panola County Farm Bureau.
Discounts may vary by situation.
If you don't have an oil well, you need to get one. So Ricky and Casey Bagley at Bagley Well Services can help you take care of it. Bagley Well Services is a complete service. Hookups, pipelines, maintenance, backhoe, dozer, and pipe hauling. Bagley Well Service, one call does it all. 903-690-9700. 903-690-9700. Let Bagley Well Services do the work for you.
Well, he looks like to me he's hurt. He is on the ground back and forth. You could tell he was hurting. He can't put any. It's not our guy. It's one of their guys.
And you know Carson, their standout defensive end headed to Texas, is now off the team. And that's the other defensive end right there, number 81. So they now have both of their starting defensive ends from last week out of the ball game as of right now. It was a 3-yard gain, fourth down and three for Carthage at the Eylau 42. Carthage going for it. Snap back to Davis. Davis going to run for it. And he has the first down, I think, as he dives forward for it. It's going to depend on the spot. And the fella coming in from the near side is going to have him down short of the first down. It was very close.
It is a first down.
Oh, it is a first down. Okay, very close there. And Kason Davis picks up another Garrett record service. Bulldog first down.
I think we got a favorable spot there myself.
Yeah, he could have cut toward our sideline, the visual sideline, a little bit more of an opening. Liberty-Eylau left to run a 4-2-5 defense with two linebackers, and five in the secondary. So it looks like they're trying to take away our pass.
Well, I can tell you, the guy over on the far side, okay, we've got a Carthage timeout. And for all your real estate needs, be sure and call Dustin Burns at Cowell Banker, Ken Anderson Associates, 903-754-3325. One more time, for your real estate needs, call Dustin Burns at Cowell Banker, Ken Anderson Associates, 903-754-3325.
It's not Tex-Mex, it's Fresh Mex. That's the slogan at Don Juan's in Carthage. Don Juan's open at 10:30 Monday through Sunday and staying open late on Friday and Saturday for your dining convenience. Happy hour Monday through Friday, 2 until 7. Don Juan's, where $5 lunch specials are back. Don't forget, kids eat free with the purchase of an adult meal. Don Juan's, located one block north of the square in downtown Carthage. It's great Mexican food.
Well, Mark, you mentioned that we got a good spot on the first down. I'm telling you, the line judge was coming in, and he was going to spot it short, but the head linesman got there before the line judge did, and he spotted it for the first down. So we'll take it. First and 10 now, Carthage at the Leopard 39. The ball is on the left hash as Carthage now goes again, still going left to right here in the first quarter. No score. All right, Davis under center this time. Davis. Hands off to Ingram. Ingram bounces off a tackler, gets loose now to the 35-yard line. Boy, he was hit right at the line of scrimmage and did a spin move and managed to then went to his left and picked up 4 yards on the play. He turns a one-yard loss into a 4-yard gain.
He was hit behind the line of scrimmage. It was like nobody blocked on that play at all. They had two or three guys in the backfield there.
Yeah, we went with a double tight end set, and our other second tight end is number 90, our defensive end, and he just missed a block, and number 40, their defensive end, got in there and disrupted that play.
So after the 4-yard pickup, and that was all Keontae Ingram there on that 4-yard gain, it's now 2nd and 6 for Carthage at the Eylau 35-yard line. Now we're down to 6 seconds on the play clock. Down to 4, 3, 2. Davis in the gun, snaps it with one. Davis looking to his right, great protection. Now it breaks down. It's complete to Ingram. Ingram to the 35, first down to the 30, inside of the 25, down to about the 20-yard line. Another Garrett's record service. Bulldog first down.
Good protection then by the offensive line. He stood up there tall and surveyed his first and second read and went to his third read, which is out in the flat. And then there, Liberty-Eylau threw him forward 5 yards on the tackle.
Yeah, Liberty-Eylau is so athletically talented. You know, they do such a good job here in this first series against us in open field tackling. We have not been able to shuck or juke one of their players. They're just so well talented.
All right, ball on the right hash now. We've got Bowen split to the left and Ingram to the right. Wing is Brewster on the right. Hand off to Ingram. Ingram to the 20, 15. Keontae bounces off the tackler at the 12 and is down to the 11-yard line. Elliott's helmet comes off. He'll have to come out for one play.
Flags
but
on the play.
Keontae Ingram with a 9-yard gain, but there is a flag down at the 10-yard line.
Like a preliminary, he's saying it was us, but we'll see. Holding us. And that was a good play. We got to the outside that time, which you don't get to the outside very much on this athletic team, and had good yardage, but that's going to set us back.
Incidentally, I forgot to mention the Dogs have once again crossed the Bauer Furniture Company red zone. They are in the red zone, but now this penalty sets us back to the 20-yard line. So that's where we started originally. So it's first down and 10 once again after the 10-yard penalty. So give a 10-yard gain to Keontae Ingram and then the 10-yard penalty, first and 10 at the 20. All right, Davis this time going to be in the shotgun with two receivers to the right, three to the left. Empty backfield for Keontae, for Kaysen Davis. Here comes their blitz, and he gets the pass off. It's caught by Keontae Ingram to the 15, to the 10. Oh, I tell you what, we burned them there on the blitz. They came with a blitz, and Kaysen Davis got rid of it quickly. Another Garrett's record service Bulldog first down after that pass completion of 11 yards.
Yeah, and we threw like a quick screen, and it was designed to go up the middle, but he cut it to the outside, got good yardage on the deal. We've always eat up about half of the first quarter here on this drive.
11-yard pass to Keontae Ingram, and it is almost, as Mark said, halfway through the first quarter, 6:23 and counting. Kaysen Davis under center. Eye formation behind him, tight end right. Here's a pitch out to Keontae Ingram. Ingram to his right. Ingram struggling to get yardage, and he is pushed out of bounds at about the 7-yard line. After a gain of 2, it'll be 2nd and goal from the Eylau 7.
Yeah, you can tell their speed. They have they like bees. They come around the ball carrier, come out of nowhere. Look like he has some room to run there, and all of a sudden it closed up fast.
Yeah, Surratt talked about in his speed interview with Larry that, you know, they're tough and mean on defense. We're doing a good job of being physical with them. I saw one of our receivers, DeWaylon Ingham, blocking the guy in the end zone, and Tanner Elliott from his left tackle position blocking another guy in the end zone. So we're going to be physical with these guys up front and try and wear them down.
Boy, I like to see that. Keep blocking till the whistle blows. Liberty Hill did that. That was the best team I've ever seen do that. Here's a flag on the play.
We had to jump there. So, well, I tell you what, that's one thing about Baldry last year. Baldry would be blocking until you blew the flag.
Liberty Hill, when you talk about blocking till the whistle blows, I don't think I've ever seen a team the equal of Liberty Hill that knocked us out of the playoffs in 2007.
I tell you what, we couldn't see who had the ball that game.
That's true,
and they
too.
They had a big old bumbling back, too, boy, that we couldn't stop.
All right, the 5-yard penalty moves it back to the 12. It's second and goal for Carthage at the Eylau 12. 6:10 left to play in the first quarter. Carthage has had the football for the first 5:50 of this ball game. They've controlled it. Kaysen Davis in the shotgun. Trips to the left, one receiver to the right. Davis looking left. He throws into the end zone. This ball is caught. Great catch. One-handed catch by D. Bowens for the touchdown. Wow, what a catch.
He's the playmaker from last year. You know, he's a little bitty fella, but he plays way bigger than he is. And the ball was thrown in the very corner of the end zone. He just stuck his paw out there, grabbed it, brought it in, got 1 foot in, touchdown.
Perfectly placed pass there by Davis. I thought actually – our receiver was going to slow up and not be able to catch up to it, but he did. He kind of jumped out with one arm, one that big power, and was able to reel it in for a touchdown.
Okay, the extra point brought to you by the First Methodist Church of Carthage, and this one is good. And we might mention that the touchdown, Carthage touchdown, by D. Bowens, made possible by the Bulldog Stop, where you can find Exxon Gas plus the best snacks in town. The Bulldog Shop bringing you the touchdown, First Methodist Church of Carthage. With the extra point, Carthage leads at 7-0. 6:01 left to play in the first. Back right after this.
If you need construction done, check with Carlos and Shane Courtney at Courtney Construction Incorporated. They're the best in the business, whether it's pipeline or dirt work or field maintenance or general construction. The Courtneys are well experienced. Give them a call today at 903-694-2911 or stop by 1300 Northeast Loop in Carthage. Courtney Construction Incorporated. When you need it done right, call Courtney Construction. They'll get it done.
Hey, Larry, we got to really give kudos to offensive line that time. That gave that time for that play to develop. You could see it developing when he and Bowens went the middle and then cut to the outside, and it got away from the defender. So offensive line played really good there.
And a great grab. I tell you what, if you have cable, not for Falcon cable, but Fidelity cable, channel 18, tomorrow morning there will be a replay of this, and you can see that great grab of D. Bowens for the touchdown. All right, Bulldogs ready to kick off now, up 7-0 here. Alberto Segala kicking off. Here's a sky kick, and they're going to take it at the 30-yard line, and he is tackled immediately. No fair catch. Boy, that's perfect placement. Coach Surratt likes it from about the 28 to the 32. That was right in the middle at the 30-yard line, a 2-yard return for Eylau. They have it at their 32.
Nick Moore on the tackle. But, you know, they scored 58 points last week and hardly ever threw the ball, and it's kind of hard to score that many points without having a bunch of passing yards too.
All right, let's see who they go with at quarterback, and we have a little bit of a delay here. The official, the referee Darren Lair, going to visit with his crew, and he's got a signal to the timekeeper up here in the press box. Something concerning the clock. Oh, the clock says 55 minutes and 50 seconds. That's what's wrong.
That's from last week.
Yep.
That's how long it took to get the game started.
Okay. That one had a zero in there. A zero, and it should be 5:55. Instead, it showed 5:55:0. All right, now let's see who they have at quarterback. They go with two quarterbacks. Tough to read their numbers. And, okay, this one's going to be Phillips. Phillips, play action fake, rolling to his left. He's pressured. Now he's going to try to go back to the right under heavy pressure, and he's sacked back at the 25-yard line. That's going to be a loss of 7 on the play.
Yeah, he did have a spot there that if he'd have got by those defenders, he had nothing but blockers up the right side of the line there. But good pursuit by the Bulldogs.
Great job there. Let's give kudos to that defensive line, Trey Gatlin, Austin Russell, Greg Hurst, and Monterio Wilson. All right, 2nd and 17 for Eylau now at their 25. Ball on the left hash. Here's a snap back to Phillips. Phillips hands off to Livingston. Livingston going to his right, and he picks up 4 yards on the play.
Montorio Wilson on the tackle. cleaned up by Nick Moore.
Number one, the free safety came in and cleaned him up.
Ashton Hicks.
That was Kevin Florence, pardon me, not Livingston, but Kevin Florence.
Need to stop right here.
Florence had 18 carries for 171 yards last week against Gilmer. Scored three touchdowns. And so now it's third down and 13, third and 13 for Eylau at their 29. And here's a draw play. It goes to the tailback, and he is stopped after about a one-yard gain. That was Florence on the carry. And it's going to be a punting situation now for the Liberty-Eylau Leopards.
Austin Russell was the first one to get to him. He got through him, but he slowed him up enough where Jace Dixon could come in and clean it up.
Line of scrimmage is going to be the 31. Eylau with a punt here on their first possession. Their punter is back at the 18-yard line, so that's a 13-yard drop. We have one man back deep. Fourth down and 11. Low snap, bounce back. And here's a kick. Nice kick. It's going to go over the head of Colbert. Colbert goes back, picks it up at the 15-yard line. Trying to find running room. He's in trouble. Helmet comes off. Still in trouble, and he's going to be brought down. His helmet came off. Boy, what a kick there by Liberty-Eylau. That's going to be 19 and 35 yards. That's a 54-yard kick. Colbert had it go over his head. He came back and picked it up at the 15-yard line. Lost three on the return. Carthage first and 10 at their 12.
Yeah, when you start retreating on a punt, you're in trouble because all 11 guys have broke through their blocks, and there's nowhere to go.
54-yard kick for the Leopards. And that one sailed over the head of Makai Colbert. He was the only man back deep. So Carthage now at their own 12 as they start this drive. 3:45 to play in the first. Carthage leading Eylau by a score of 7-0. All right, we're going to have one receiver to the left, two receivers to the right. Kaysen Davis in the shotgun. Ingram with him in the backfield. Snap back to Davis. Davis looking over the middle. He throws, and this one is knocked down at the line of scrimmage, incomplete.
Yeah, he had some other receivers open, too. He had D. Bowens over the middle kind of open, and then looked like might have been on the other side of the field one open, but somebody knocked it down.
Second down for Carthage at their own 12-yard line. Again, Carthage scoring on a touchdown pass to D. Bowens, 12-yard pass. Extra point was good. Carthage up now 7-0. He scored on the opening drive. Second down and 10. Davis under center. Davis, play action fake, rose to his left. He's being pressured. He throws, and this ball is almost picked off. That was behind the intended receiver, Josh Gradberg, and one of the Leopards came close to getting it.
Yeah, when you throw across your body like that, only Brett Favre could hardly do that. Most people cannot turn, go to their left and throw from the right. It's just hard to do.
One thing is with this 4-2-5 defense, they basically got an extra safety that plays up there behind the linebackers, and he was taking the inside receiver on the out route, but he recognized the play with the tight end trailing, so he went back, and I think that's why Kaysen threw it more back away so he wouldn't have the interception.
All right, we've got 10 seconds left on the play clock. Davis going to be in the shotgun, third down and 10 after two incomplete passes. Twins to the right, one to the left. Here's Kaysen Davis looking over the middle. He throws over the middle. It is caught for a first down for D. Bowens. Another Garris Record Service Bulldog first down out to the 27-yard line.
That was almost Blissett-like speed. He threw that ball like a fastball over the middle. D. Bowens caught it. First down, Dogs.
First down, number 6 in the ball game for the Carthage Bulldogs. D. Bowens, 4 receptions for 43 yards. Keontae Ingram, 1 for 11. DeWaylon Ingram, 1 for 15. Roderick Calloway, 1 for 3. Kaysen Davis is now 8 out of 10 for 71 yards. He was 8 out of 9 last week at Gladewater in the abbreviated game. First and 10, Dogs. After that, Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down. Here's a handoff to Ingram. Big hole, 30, 35. First down across the 40. Another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down all the way out to the 42-yard line.
Now, he made some moves there that we hadn't seen in a while at tailback, maybe since Dwight Smith. You know, we didn't really get to see him a whole lot last year. He was banged up with a hip corner and last year, most of the year. And then we played Navasota. We found out what we had in him when he'd run off and left everything Navasota had. I'd like to see him have a good game, get one under his belt.
I tell you what, you know, Dustin – Coach Surratt has been saying this year he's going to give him some rest in these pre-district games, but I don't think he's missed a play from scrimmage yet.
No, we haven't. We've had him out there at receiver and most of him out of the backfield at receiver. And, you know, we talked about how important our run game is with our offense. And it's going to take a little time for this, you know, semi-new offensive line that we got tonight for this season. We got two guys from last year, so we got three new guys plus a tight end. So it may take them a couple of games to get there, you know, to gel together and get things going. But, you know, that run game as the season goes along in the playoffs will be very important for the Bulldog offense.
First down and 10. After the delay, the official coming over to visit with the Liberty-Eylau coach, Scott Wells. First and 10 for Carthage now at their own 42. Keontae Ingram goes motion left out of the backfield, now split out as a receiver. Snap back to Davis, empty backfield. And the pass is caught by Keontae Ingram, and they are on him immediately. That's going to be no gain on that pass completion. Second and 10.
That was that quick screen that we ran earlier that we had a little bit of success on. They were subject to Gilmer's, like Coach said, 45 screens last week. So I'm sure that they worked on it this week. 2:07 left in the first period, 7-0 Carthage.
Second and 10 for the Bulldogs at their 42-yard line. Remember, this drive started at the 12, and it's second and 10 now. We've got a little bit of confusion, it appears, over there, but still 11 seconds left on the play clock. Two receivers split out to the left. That's the short side of the field. Ball on the left hash. Here's a handoff to Keontae Ingram. Running room, 45. Cuts back to the right to the 50. What a move there to the 45. Another Garrett's record service Bulldog first down to the Liberty-Eylau 43-yard line.
Well, he'll get a break there because his helmet came off, so he'll get it sit out at least one play.
You know, I'd like to see him, instead of cutting back across that field, go a little bit more downfield and get what he can get instead of cutting back across the flow of traffic there with those guys trailing. But, you know, he's one of the ones that can do it. He's got the moves and the speed, and we saw that as the season went on last year and into the playoffs.
Okay, for the first time this year, Keontae Ingram not in there on an offensive snap. He has to go out because the helmet came off, and Brewster Griffith is going to be in there in the backfield with him. Appears to be a little bit of confusion now here on this play, but still 9 seconds left on the play clock. Shotgun, first and 10, Davis with it on the snap. Great protection. He's throwing deep down the far side, incomplete, intended over there for D. Bowens at the 15-yard line.
I think that he kind of pulled off that throw and threw it to the left a little bit because there was a safety. Looked like he had a bead on it, and if he'd have thrown it perfect right there. So that may have made him throw it off a little bit.
Yeah, I think Kaysen was leading him more up the hashes straight down the field, and D was going a little bit towards the end. That safety was coming over, but Kaysen's looked good so far here tonight and the first, you know, quarter and a half last week.
He's had time. He's been standing back here with plenty of time.
All right, now Davis in the shotgun here. Three receivers to the left, snap back to him. He's looking left, throwing left. This ball is caught by Bowens for another first down inside the 25-yard line. Another Garrett's record service Bulldog first down. It'll be at the 23.
A pretty pass, too. I mean, it's on a bullet, and it gets to him fast. But the little playmaker, I guarantee you, is going to make plenty of plays for this year.
And he has such great vision because when he looked up, he was looking for that ball over his outside shoulder, and the ball was on his inside, so he had to go back and get it right there with the defender over his back. So another good pass and catch there from Davis to Bowens.
Well, if you don't think D. Bowens is valuable, 5 catches tonight, 62 yards. That's a 19-yarder right there. And, again, another Garrett's record service Bulldog first down, 1:07 to play in the first quarter. Clock should be moving. It's not.
And, you know,
and the officials finally see that.
Last week we threw the ball to Callaway, and it looks like to me they're trying to take Callaway out of it. Bowens wasn't around last week.
That's right.
So this week they tried to stop Callaway. Looks like they're doubling on him, and that's going to leave – they're going to have to account for D somewhere.
Now, yeah. Boy, what a luxury to have this many receivers that draw the attention of defenses like that.
And you know, that even if they try and do cover, you know, D Moore or Roderick, that's going to open up for DeWaylon Ingham. He's a good receiver. He only had one catch last week, but he has good hands. He's about 6'1" and good, tall, lanky structure, and he can be a good receiver as the season goes along as well.
And yeah, also it'll open Gradberg up, too, if they try to do this. So.
And we don't even have Chris Attaway out there tonight. So, and also not out there is Keelan Shelton. He's not in there tonight. Okay, first down and 10 for Carthage. As we had a problem with the clock, now they've got it rolling. All right, first down and 10 for Carthage at the Eylau 4-yard line. Davis under center, ball on the left hash. Handoff goes to Brewster Griffith. Griffith is going to be wrapped up for no gain. Okay, no gain there. Be second down and 10.
Well, when they grab your helmet, there's nothing much you can do. I mean, they grabbed him around the helmet, not the face mask. So it's, your head's going to follow that helmet wherever it goes. 20 seconds left in the half. Looks like it's going to be our last play.
All right, this will probably be the final play of the first quarter. Carthage leading at 7-0. 11 seconds left in the quarter. Here's Davis. There's a flag on the play. Davis throwing toward the right near side. This ball is up in the air, incomplete. And let's see. I think Ilo was offside on this.
Yeah, and I think we're going to have a flag for pass interference because the official threw his hat.
Well, he threw his hat. Don't he throw his hat when he steps out of bounds?
He threw his hat if he doesn't have a flag. He threw his flag over here on the sideline, so
okay,
we could have two.
Okay.
We could have two penalties as well.
Good. We got 1.3 seconds, so we're going to run this next play too.
Oh, two penalties, offside and pass interference. So we will take the pass interference.
1.3 seconds left in the quarter, first quarter, 7-0 Carthage, and we're inside, it's going to be now inside the 20.
So offside is declined. The other penalty is accepted. And as Mark has just reminded me, all right, the Dogs have once again crossed the Bauer Furniture Company red zone, into that red zone for the second time in the ball game tonight. It's going to be a penalty down to the 9-yard line, first and goal for the Bulldogs. That's another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down. First and goal now at the 9. Carthage leading at 7-0, 1.3 seconds left to play here in the first quarter. All right, Bulldogs come up to the line of scrimmage. Kaysen Davis going to be under center. Eye formation behind him in the backfield. And a wide receiver to each side. Tight end left. Pitch out Brewster Griffith. Griffith going left. Griffith is down to the 5, and that ends the first quarter. It'll be a 4-yard pickup to the 5-yard line. It'll be second down and goal.
Fidelity Communications is
when we
ready
come back
to turbocharge your internet service with this amazing offer. You can get 125 megabit internet with 6 months of free Wi-Fi for just $79.99 per month for the first year. New Fidelity Communications customers get special pricing on all three different internet packages, ranging from 25 to 125 megabits per second, starting as low as $24.99 per month. Call 1-800-392-8070 or visit us online at fidelitycommunications.com.
The ladies at the Popcorn Place are ready to take care of your floral needs. They offer cut flower arrangements, memorials, and potted plants. If there is a special occasion in the future, such as a birthday or anniversary, or maybe just a special arrangement, let the ladies at the Popcorn Place assist you with your selection. And don't forget that they carry some wonderful gift items like crystal and pottery and have a bridal registry as well. This can all be found at the Popcorn Place on West Panola in Carthage, 903-693-5421.
Where are you listening to me tonight? 903-692-3836. Text me, 903-692-3836.
We begin the second quarter. Carthage up 7-0. And, of course, we switch ends of the field. So Carthage will now be going to from our right to left. They're headed toward the west goal line here, the west end zone, I should say, at Harris Field, home of the Liberty-Eylau Leopards. Brand new artificial turf down for this ball game. First game to be played on it here tonight. All right, Carthage up 7-0. And it's going to be second and goal for the Carthage Bulldogs at the Eylau 6-yard line. The ball is going to be on the left hash, as Kaysen Davis will take this snap in the shotgun. He's got one receiver to the left and two to the right. Griffith with him in the backfield. Now the wide out from the on the right side goes motion left. Davis with it, rolling to his right. Going to throw back to the left. He's got it. And the ball is going to be caught by Gradberg. And it's a touchdown. Josh Gradberg with the reception. And it is a 6-yard TD reception. This touchdown is brought to you by the Bulldog Stop, where you can find Exxon Gas plus the best snacks in town.
I tell you what, that was a beautifully set up play. It was kind of like the play we ran in the second drive against Cold Springs, where we rolled everybody to the right and then we threw it back to the left. There's nobody there to get him.
All right, this extra point will be brought to you by the First Methodist Church
decided to go to Winkle
Carthage
Place.
And here's the kick by DeJulian. It is up and good. First Methodist Church extra point. It's good by Jose DeJulian. Carthage leads it 14-0, 11:52 to play in the second quarter.
In my mind, God gave me the answer. And I'm in Winter Place now, and I enjoy living there. I have everything I need. I'm happy at Winter Place.
When I picture Panola, I picture opportunity. A chance to pursue my dream of becoming a nurse, one of the fastest-growing occupations in the U.S. with the potential to earn up to $82,000 a year. Panola's small class size allows me to receive personalized attention at a cost I can afford, and their state-of-the-art simulation labs allow me to develop excellent nursing skills. I'm excited to jumpstart my nursing career with Panola College. What does Panola College look like for you? Picture your Panola. Visit panola.edu today.
Well, Liberty-Eylau hadn't much time to have the ball, have they?
They have not.
They had it about 2.5 minutes or so.
Let's see. They have run three plays. Let's see. Liberty-Eylau has run three plays, four counting the punt. Carthage has run, let me get it real quick, 6, 7, 9, 12, 15, 18, 22 plays. 22 plays to three so far. All right. Sigala ready to kick off for the Bulldogs. Last time it was a sky kick. And that's what he's lined up to do this time, it appears. The first one, he kicked it to the 30-yard line. And here's the sky kick. This is going to go a little deeper. And they're going to let it bounce. They take it at the 21, coming right to the 25. And he stopped it at the 30-yard line. Here comes a couple of flags in the point where the tackle was made. Probably going to go against Carthage right here on the penalty.
You could see it stand out big time. Well, they're listening to me from Spring, Texas. Kenmare, North Dakota. McKinney, Arlington.
Okay, 15-yard penalty against Carthage. And you can't find too much to complain about so far with the Bulldogs, but that is our third penalty for 30 yards. You know Scott Surratt will address that this coming week. All right, Liberty-Eylau with the football now. And here's a handoff. Pretty good running room this time to the 50 and across the 50 to the 47-yard line. That's going to be a gain of 8 on the play for DeAndre Hoof.
Nick Moore on the tackle along with Jason Dixon, I believe. 11:30 left here in the first half. We're ahead 14-0.
Okay, the quarterback is DeCorian Phillips. Phillips with it, throws left. This is caught out there in the flat, and a great one-on-one tackle there for no gain by one of the Bulldogs. Don't know who that was for sure, but it's no gain, third down and two coming up.
It's DeJulian, and he was fighting off a block and made an open field tackle. What a great play there. No gain.
All right, now it is third down and two. Third down and two for Liberty-Eylau. They have yet to pick up a first down in this ball game. Carthage with 11 first downs. Third and two. Carthage leads it 14-0 early here in the second quarter. Third down and two from the Carthage 47. Snap back to Phillips. Phillips with a handoff. Here's a first down for Hoof. Hoof across the 40 down to the 35. And that's going to be a first down for Liberty-Eylau, their first of the ball game.
I think that we were blitzing on that play. We had no linebackers once he got through the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, and it was like a little option keeper here. The quarterback could pull it and run or hand it off. And when we came in like that, it opened up the play to the tailback.
All right, first and 10 now for the Leopards at the Carthage 34. Snap back to Phillips. Phillips hands off to the running back coming to his right this time. And he's going to be lassoed and dropped to the ground after about a one-yard gain. That was Levingston on the carry.
Well, he tried to get to the outside that time, and we wouldn't let him get to the outside. Cornerback stuck his ground there and turned him in, and the pursuit happened from behind.
The defense is doing a good job of being physical and swarming to the ball because this is only their second series on the field here with 9:55 left in the second quarter. Carthage up 14-0.
Second down and 9 for Eylau now at the Carthage 33. Snap back to Phillips. Phillips handoff to Hoof. Hoof up the middle, and he's going to be stopped at about the 30-yard line. That's a gain of 3, and Ilo's going to face now third down and 6.
Yeah, and this isn't their four-down territory. They're a running team, so they're not scared probably to go for fourth down here. So we need a good play right here to make them go out of their game plan and maybe try to throw it.
Third and six for the Leopards. Carthage leading 14 to nothing. 9:20 left to play in the half. Eylau with it now at the Carthage 30-yard line. Phillips in the shotgun. Snap back to him. Option to the right. Phillips cuts upfield with it, and he picks up about 3 yards. That's going to bring up fourth down and three after that gain of three.
Yeah, and they tried to get to the outside again in our pursuits there. They've gained 8 yards in three plays, so this is when we need a good defensive stop right here.
Fourth and three for Liberty-Eylau at the Carthage 27-yard line. Ball is going to be on the right hash, and they're going to send two receivers to the left and one to the right. They very seldom throw the football. Phillips in the shotgun. We're faking the blitz there. Now we drop back. 10 seconds left on the play clock. Phillips changing the play now at the line of scrimmage. Now the play clock is down to 4, 3, 2.
They jumped.
And who jumped?
They did.
Liberty-Eylau jumped. All right, so Liberty-Eylau with the play clock winding down.
Spent too much time.
Yep.
Offensive lineman's got his hand on the ground too long. And he's trying to get ahead of his blocker, the one he's blocking, and he just can't stand it. Just takes off.
So now that turns a fourth and three into a fourth and eight, and Liberty-Eylau is going to call a timeout. We'll take a timeout also here at Harris Field in Texarkana.
At Panola National Bank, we're constantly looking for ways to make community banking even better. Now we're making it easier for you to bank on the go with Mobile PNB. Our new mobile banking service allows you to access your accounts directly from your cell phone so you can make transfers, check balances, and search transactions all from the convenience of your cell phone or tablet. Be sure to check out our new free mobile apps in the iTunes Store and the Google Play Store. Panola National Bank, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
This is Walter Sparks with XL Ford Lincoln Mercury here in Carthage, encouraging y'all to come out and see our large inventory of new cars, trucks, and SUVs. We have rebates up to $8,000 on selected models, a good selection of pre-owned cars and trucks at very affordable prices, financing available with excellent service and parts. Check out our website, XL Ford of Carthage, for updates on a regular basis. Remember, we're still on the South Loop and we're still number one.
Fourth down and eight, snap back to Phillips. Phillips wants to throw, going to go deep toward the end zone. This ball is overthrown in the end zone, and Carthage will take over after holding on downs. First and 10 Bulldogs at their own 32-yard line.
Good defensive stop. Now they've had the ball twice. We stopped them both times.
Yeah, he had a step on one of our cornerbacks, but we had a little bit of safety over the top, a little bit of help, and quarterback had a throw where the only receiver could catch it, and it was a little bit too far out of his reach. Good play there by the defense. They're playing real good tonight, playing physical and being tough up there in the middle with those big offensive linemen that LE has.
All right, the Bulldogs now first and 10 at their own 32. The ball is spotted about 4 yards to the right of the left hash. And Kason Davis will be in the shotgun here with two receivers split to the right, and now two to the left. Empty backfield. Four wideouts on this formation. Snap back to Davis. He's looking left, looking left. Now he throws left high, intended for Ingram, and the ball is tipped a couple of times by Ingram and then caught for a loss. He had to dive for it to come down with it, and it's a loss of three on the play.
Well, you can't blame a man for hustle, but right then he was trying to catch it, but he was falling backwards. That's why it was a loss. They're listening to us in Henderson, at Pope Quarters, at 40. And last week's game did not count, does it? They showed it in Longview paper that we were 1-0, but it was no contest.
I think officially it's 0-0. I think it didn't count.
Yeah, it didn't count. We came in this game with a 0-0 record.
Okay, second down and 13 now for Carthage after that loss of three. Second down and 13 at our 29. Empty backfield after Ingram goes motion left. Snap back to Davis, looking right this time, throwing right. This ball is caught by Bowens, gets loose from a tackler to the 30, drops it, then falls on it. He dropped it, then fell on it. And we have the officials calling timeout. We've got a flag on the play. I just see the flag now at the 26-yard line.
Well, he was trying to get away. He juked two guys, but then he dropped the ball. He juked the ball out of his hand.
Personal foul against Liberty-Eylau. So let's see where they mark that off now from. That's going to be from the line of scrimmage, and that's 15 yards. So that will be a first down for Carthage. Another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down.
That must have been a late hit on Kaysen, because there was a guy had a beat on him when he threw it. And I watched the ball from then on.
Yeah, Bowens did a good job on the out route, going, turned back around, trying to get upfield. And then whenever he tried to miss another receiver, the ball got knocked out.
First and 10 Dogs from their own 44. Bowens goes motion right now. Davis under center. Pitch out Keontae Ingram going right to the 45. Midfield. Stiff arm. Out of bounds at the 45. Late flag flies. This is going to be, I think, a 12-yard gain for Keontae Ingram and maybe a late hit on Eylau.
I tell you what, he made a move. He juked a guy completely out of his shoes in.
Yeah, it's. Like you said earlier, Mark, that's kind of Dwight Smithish right there. I mean, that guy was almost going to the ground whenever Keontae got about 2 yards outside him.
You can tell those hips,
move.
Those swivel hips he's got. 7 minutes left in the first half, 14-0 Carthage, and we have the ball again.
Another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down. The gain was 12 to the Eylau 44, and then tack on 15 more. So they've now picked up two 15-yard penalties on this drive. And Carthage all of a sudden has a first down at the Liberty-Eylau 29-yard line, leading 14-0, 7 minutes to play here in the first quarter. And remember, last week, Eylau lost a close one to Gilmer by a score of 61-55. Okay, Kaysen Davis under center here. Offset eye to the right this time. Hand off to Keontae Ingram. Ingram dancing around and almost got loose. If he gets loose from that guy, who knows? He might have scored, but he's brought down for no gain.
He was like, that looked like Barry Sanders that time. He was bouncing like a pin, you know, inside of a foosball machine until he found a way out. And when he got a way out, the guy barely grabbed him by a shoestring.
Yeah, but there's only so much juking you're going to be do against this LA defense. He's got to get upfield. Surratt told him, run upfield on that play. He had a little bit of a gap, but, you know, if it's only 4 yards, that's a good 4 yards.
That's right.
All right, second down and 10 for Carthage now at the Liberty-Eylau 29-yard line. Kaysen Davis under center. Offset eye again, this time to the right. Now Gradberg goes motion left. Okay, here's Davis, straight drop back, five-step drop. Going into the end zone, this ball is incomplete down there, just a little bit underthrown, and it's going to bring up third down and 10.
Well, he had his man beat. It might have been underthrown just a little bit, but they allow that shading in high school football where you throw your hands up in the air in front of the receiver. They allow that in high school football.
Yeah, but since the defender had his back to the ball, D would have come back toward it and made contact. Pass interference, that's what Coach Surratt was telling them there after the play was over. Come back toward it, get that penalty.
Yep, you're right. Okay, that was intended for D Bowens. Almost a 29-yard touchdown, but instead it's third down and 10 from the Liberty-Eylau 29. We're down to 8 seconds left on the play clock. Got a little bit of confusion. Now down to four. Let's see if we call a timeout here. Down to 2-1. Snap back to Davis. Davis looking right. He's throwing right. This ball is caught by D. Bowens. Bowens gets loose from the defender to the 20. Inside the 20 to the 15. Going to be another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down on the 14-yard completion to D. Bowens.
Boy, he got the ball, and he drugged the defenders. That guy is small but stout, and we'll make a play for you.
Had a little bit of help from Gradberg, grabbing him and pulling him toward the 15-yard line as well.
That's why you like teammates.
And the Bulldogs have once again crossed the Bauer Furniture Company's red zone. They're in the red zone at the Liberty-Eylau 15-yard line, 5:53 to go here in the first half. Carthage up 14-0. Kaysen Davis in the shotgun. Two receivers to the left, one to the right. Snap back to Davis. Davis this time goes to the right to Callaway. Callaway stopped immediately. Ball comes loose, and let's see. It's on the far sideline. What are they going to rule there?
I don't know if the whistle wasn't blown yet.
It's going to be ruled a fumble and ball out of bounds. Still our ball.
Way back. Right.
Yeah.
Okay, so the line of scrimmage was the 16. It was a fumble, and it wound up being a completion and a 12-yard lost on that play.
Did he just jerk it out of his hand, Dustin? Is that how that ball came out?
We had a guy coming out there to block a defender, and it looks like he ran into those two guys at one time and knocked the ball loose.
Second down. Here's flags on the play. Davis throwing into the end zone. This ball is caught there.
No, it's dropped.
No, that's dropped. Okay, and there's another flag in the end zone. So we've got two flags on the play. At the beginning of the play and then at the end.
So you got his interference that time.
Well,
didn't you?
It may be on us.
Okay. Well, I think we jumped up front.
Liberty-Eylau?
Our left guard jumped.
Offside against Eylau. Pass interference against Eylau.
Oh, okay.
How about wrong. That?
He must have been.
He must have. I saw Callaway's arm out, and I guess he was grabbing hold of his, the defender was grabbing hold of his arm because he tried to catch it with one hand at the back of the end zone. So,
for the second time in the ball game, two infractions on the same play against Liberty-Eylau. The offside turned down. The interference is accepted.
That's an automatic first down.
And that goes from the 28 down to the, or 23 down to the 8-yard line, 15-yard penalty.
You know, we're doing a good job of mixing the run, the pass, getting different receivers involved. Brewster's gotten the ball a little bit at running back. And, you know, we're doing a good job, really, of trying to find some weak spots in defense and at the same time wearing them down.
All right, first and goal now. First and goal as we get the help of that penalty. First and goal at the Liberty-Eylau 8-yard line. 5:37 to play in the half. Carthage up 14-0. Snap back to Davis. Davis looking left. Looking left. Being pressured. Now he's rolling to his left under heavy pressure, and he throws it away.
Good pass. That's what you need to do when you're in a bind. Good senior leadership. This play's not working. Get rid of it. 5:30 left in the half. 14-0 Carthage.
And Liberty-Eylau was blitzing two linebackers, and we picked it up, and I think we just had too many on our left side of our offense to block them. Case needed a smart move, get out of the pocket, avoid the sack, and throw it away.
Second and goal after the incomplete pass. Second and goal for Carthage at the Liberty-Eylau 8. Bulldogs looking over the sideline to get the call from Coach Surratt. 10 seconds left on the play clock. We've got 5:30 left to play here in the half. Snap back to Davis. Davis hands off on the draw to Keontae Ingram. He is stopped for a loss. That's going to bring up third down and long here. It's going to be a loss of 1 yard back to the 15-yard line.
Well, it's like Dustin said, we're going to have to learn. Our offensive line is going to have to learn their blocking schemes. We didn't look like we blocked hardly anybody that time. We're pass protecting pretty good, but getting a running lane's not there.
Actually, a loss of 2, so it's 3rd and 12. 3rd and 12 for Carthage from the Liberty-Eylau 15. 3rd and 12 from the 15-yard line. 4:48 and counting here in the second quarter. Carthage up 14-0. 3 seconds left on the play clock. 2-1. Snapped it with 1. Davis looking right. Looking right. Throws into the end zone. This ball is caught. Touchdown for the Bulldogs. That's going to be a 13-yard pass, and I think that went to D. Bowens. It was
they
to D. Bowens.
Cover that boy.
Oh, man.
4:30. Great.
I tell
pitch
you what,
too, right in the corner of the edge of the end zone.
Perfectly placed. He did a out and in. I mean, excuse me, out and up. And perfectly placed by Casey Davis. I mean, I tell you, he has great accuracy. We've had a lot of quarterbacks come through here, and he is filling in the footsteps of some of these other ones. And D was right there to catch at the corner of the end zone to pile him.
All right, here's the First United Methodist Church extra point attempt, and it is going to be good. Incidentally, the Carthage touchdown was made possible by the Bulldog Stop, where you can find Exxon Gas, plus the best snacks in town, and the First United Methodist Church extra point. Good. Carthage leads at 21-0. 4:35 to play in the first half. Back right after this.
At Carthage Furniture, Monty Bacon and his staff have a deal for you. A sofa and love seat in dark brown or tan, your choice. Now add 3 tables and 2 beautiful lamps, and it's yours for just $7.99. That's a sofa, love seat, 3 tables, 2 lamps, yours for $7.99. Or check this out, a red or brown love seat and sofa for $9.68. Speak Spanish? Monty can help. Carthage Furniture on West Panola in Carthage.
Here at First State Bank and Trust Company, we know that life can get busy. Since banking is a necessary part of life, but not always a productive use of your day, we're pleased to offer Mobile Deposit to make depositing checks faster and easier. Using an improved mobile device with internet access, Mobile Deposit allows you to snap a picture of the front and the back of your check, and then submit the check securely to your account, giving you more time to spend on the things that matter. Serving East Texas since 1902, First State Bank and Trust Company, Carthage.
Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
I want to give a shout-out to a friend of mine, Joe Hale, who is a sports writer, writes for the Tyler paper now, and Joe was covering a game at Brook Hill this past Saturday night, and walking down from the press box in the stands, he fell and broke his leg. And, Joe, I know you told me you're on the injured reserve for about 6 weeks now. You may be listening to the game right now. Wish you the best. Okay, Carthage getting ready to kick off, 4:35 to play, and here's the kick. And it's going to be taken at the 8-yard line, coming right to the 10, 15, 20, 25. Pretty good coverage there by the Bulldogs. And they push him out of bounds at about the 28-yard line. Boy, a lot of dogs around the football here tonight on defense.
They sure are. And they were swarming in, too. One of them was trying to jerk the ball out, while the rest of them was holding him up. 4:26 left. 21 to nothing Carthage here in the first half.
All right, let's see who's going to be in at quarterback. They've gone with Phillips so far. They have another one, Isaiah Cross, but it's going to be Phillips again at quarterback. And with him in the backfield is going to be Kevin Lawrence and Cameron Levingston. Phillips this time hands off to Levingston, going to the left. Levingston in trouble, and it's going to be brought down for a loss. It's going to be a loss back inside the 25-yard line, a loss of four on the play.
Trey Gatlin calls that to him to go to the outside and then caught him from behind. When he slowed up because McHale was sitting there waiting to tackle him.
Yeah, Trey, he's so tall, 6 foot six, I think 240, 250 is what they had him weighed in at. He's so long, he's able to stretch out his arm and slow him up till linebacker got there and he finished off the tackle.
Second down and 14 for Eylau, now at their own 24. Snap back to Phillips. Phillips handing off to Levingston again, this time going left again. And he's going to be stopped after a gain of about three. They lost four and then they pick up three. Third down and 11 coming up for the Leopards.
Yeah, so far we've kept them bottled up and given any kind of a long play of any kind. 3:35 left in the first half, 21-0 Carthage.
All right, the ball is on the Liberty-Eylau 27-yard line.
Don't need to give them any kind of momentum right now. Play defense, make them punt it.
Ball is on the left hash, third down and 11 for Eylau. Snap back to Phillips. Phillips, play action fake. He's going to throw, and this one is knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Trey Gatlin got it. Fourth down and 11 coming up for Liberty-Eylau at their 27-yard line. The big guy got it.
That's our two-tall Jones right there. He's so lanky. That ought to be in his repertoire. Every time the passer goes back to throw, if he didn't make the tackle, his hands ought to be in the air.
So this will be another kick here for Liberty-Eylau. And remember, their first one was a 54-yarder. Let's see if Colbert backs up backs up some more on this one. Line of scrimmage will be the 27. And they take this time a 12-yard drop. Remember the first snap, bounced back. Waist-high snap this time. Wait a minute, the officials blow it dead. And I don't see a flag on the play. That's going to be delay of game. Delay of game against Liberty-Eylau. That'll be their sixth penalty for 66 yards. And that will move them back now to the 20, should be to the 22, and it is at the 22. Fourth and very long for Eylau at their 22. We have Colbert back deep. Here's the kick, and this one is not as long, and Cobra's going to take it at the 43-yard line to the 45. Now spins loose, going left, flag on the play, and he does cross midfield, but there is a flag at the 49-yard line.
That's going to be, you know, that always happens on a punt, blocking the back or some kind of infraction because it's way downfield.
Sometimes, you know, I think we're a little aggressive, and you know, right there with 2:55 left, we want to get some good field position right about the 50-yard line. You know, that's going to move us back 15. And had a couple of penalties there on the first drive in the red zone, but we were able to score. You just got to watch, you know, what we do and play a little bit more smart, a little bit more smarter, and let our guys that get the ball do what they can do with it.
And good point on that, because that flag was thrown pretty good distance from where the tackle was made. So, in other words, it was no really consequence on the play except it moves Carthage back 10 yards. Four penalties now against the Bulldogs for 40 yards, and so Carthage will start this drive from their 39. 2:55 left to play in the half.
Plenty of time.
Carthage up 21-0. Three touchdown passes tonight, two to D. Bowens and the other one to Josh Gradbert. All right, Kaysen Davis in the shotgun, snap back to him. Going to throw to Ingram out of the backfield. Ingram to the 40, to the 45, to the 50-yard line. Dancing around and is going to be stopped at about the ILO 49-yard line. Another Garrett's record service, Bulldog first down.
Oh, yeah. He's got – when he gets his legs under him for the year, he's going to be awesome. He has just got great moves. And that was a quick screen out there to him with lead blockers in front of him.
Yeah, sometimes I wish he wouldn't do so much dancing, do about one or two moves and get upfield and get going. Cause
they'll work on that.
Yeah. You know, you have a chance of the mother defenders coming over there and, you know, having a chance of losing the ball, fumbling it.
All right, first and 10 now at the ILO 48-yard line. Kaysen Davis in the shotgun, snap back to him. Handoff goes to Ingram. Ingram up the middle of the 45 and stopped at the 41-yard line after a gain of 7.
Guess we're keeping them honest with the run. We got plenty of time. Got two timeouts left.
Okay, they spotted at the 42, so we'll give him 6 yards. Two timeouts remaining, as Mark said. 2:24 left to play in the half. Carthage leading by a score of 21-0. Second down and 4 for Carthage at the Liberty-Eylau 37. 12 seconds left on the play clock. Davis in the shotgun, snap back to him. He's looking over the middle now. He's being flushed out of the pocket. Flag on the play, rolls to his right, throws downfield. This ball is caught there by Shelton. Shelton out of bounds at the 20, inside the 20-yard line at the 18. There is a flag on the play.
Holding.
Yeah, they had a man come free and ended up with their man ended up with his helmet off, like somebody might have held him as they come in. So that's going to march us back a little bit. 21-0 Carthage here. In the game that was billed to be supposed to be a shootout, but, you know, they scored a bunch of points last game in the second half. So they can score.
Okay, mark off 10 against the Bulldogs. So now that is 50 yards in penalties against Carthage. And that takes it back across midfield to the Carthage 48, 1:57 in the half, 21-0 Bulldogs. And it's now second and 14 for Carthage from the Carthage 48. Ball in the middle of the field with respect to the sidelines. Davis going to be in the shotgun. 4 seconds on the play clock. 3, 2, 1. Snap with 1. Davis, play action fake. Throws over the middle of this ball. It's caught by Bowens at the 35. Bowens is still on his feet now. Knocked down at the 32-yard line. That's going to be another Bulldog first down. Garrett's record service, Bulldog first down.
That tickled me. A guy from Liberty-Eylau jumps up like he had done something like Superman, but he just gave up 15 or 20 yards.
Yeah, he put a hit on me as D was trying to miss a defender and go around. Big hit.
All right, first and 10 now for Carthage at the ILO 20. I make it the 32-yard line. 1:35 to play Bowens in the first half. Snap back to Davis. Davis in the shotgun, looking right, throwing right. It's caught by Keontae Ingram to the 25-20. Another Garrett's record service. Bulldog first down for the Bulldogs.
Bowen's got something bothering him. He's, and that hit he took, I saw him waving at the coaches before the play started.
Yeah, he took a pretty good leak there. Might have got the breath knocked out of him. But on that pass by Keontae Ingram, he pleaded a defender for Liberty-Eylau. Just ran over him.
14 yards on that pass completion. First down and 10 now for Carthage at the Liberty-Eylau 18. 1:25 to go. 1:25 to play in the half. Carthage up 21-0. Davis in the shotgun. Snap back to him. Option to the right. Davis going to keep it himself and goes out of bounds. That ought to be a late hit right there. There's a flag. Liberty-Eylau hit him after he was out of bounds. A 3-yard pickup. That's the first option play we've seen this year. And, boy, you don't see too many of those ever in the Scott Surratt offense.
No.
Option to the right. Is that the first one in 10 years? I don't know.
I don't remember if I've ever seen it before, unless it was a back running the Maverick or whatever, you Wildcat.
3 yards by Davis. And then the knocked the hit out of bounds was at the 15.
Well, that's what happens when you start getting teams putting it on you pretty good. You start losing your temper, and you hit late, and that's what's causing all this. They were expected to be in this game, and right this first half, we pretty much put it all over.
And, you know, we're being physical on both sides of the ball, on offense and defense, matching that intensity and doing a good job here with 1:20 left here in the second quarter. Carthage up 21-0.
First and goal now at the 7, just outside the 7. Davis under center. Handoff goes to Grooster. Griffith fumble on the play. Liberty-Eylau says they've got it.
Well, hey.
And they do. That's the first turnover of the ball game. And it came in the red zone. Incidentally, I forgot to mention that the Dogs crossed again the Bauer Furniture Company red zone. But we commit our first turnover of the ball game, first turnover for either team.
And that's a bad area, too, to turn it over. You're at least going to get a field goal out of the deal.
And it comes at the Liberty-Eylau 8-yard line with 1:10 to play in the first half.
The exchange wasn't too good between the two, and I don't know what caused it. But he never did have a handle on it.
All right, now let's see. Phillips in the shotgun for Liberty-Eylau. Snap back to him, and he hands off to the running back, and the running back, I think this is Livingston, is out to about the 13 for a gain of 5 on the play.
A host of Bulldogs there on the tackle. McHale comes up from the bottom.
And that will take us under a minute. 52 seconds left to play in the half. Phillips in the shotgun again. Again, handoff to the running back, going to the right this time. And he's to the 20 and out of bounds at about the 24-yard line. That's going to be a first down.
That's their biggest gain of the night, isn't it?
It is. Goes from the 13 to the 24, a gain of 11 yards. Second first down of the ball game for Liberty-Eylau. They have it first down and 10 at their 24, 42 seconds to go now in the half. And the handoff, running back going left this time. And it stopped after a gain on the play of about 4.
Dixon.
And timeout called by Liberty-Eylau. Liberty-Eylau calls a timeout. We'll take a break also.
September is kicking off. We got up to 20% off on select GMC half-ton pickups 2016 models. We got up to 16% off on select 2016 Silverado models, not to mention 0% for 72 months on all 2016 Chevrolet models, excluding your base entry value packages. So come see us. We're Pippin Motor Company. We're located across from Panola College or on the web at pippinmotorcompany.com.
President Harry S. Truman once said, "If men and nations would but live by the precepts of the ancient prophets and the teachings of the Sermon on the Mount, problems which now seem so difficult would soon disappear." Hi, this is Dennis Smith, inviting you to come and worship with us, Central Baptist Church in Carthage. On Sunday, our services are at 9:30 a.m. and 10:45 a.m.
All right, here's Liberty-Eylau with it, and the throw to the right side is incomplete on second down and 6. And so Liberty-Eylau will now face 3rd and 6 from their 28-yard line. 31.8 seconds left to play here in the half. Carthage leading Liberty-Eylau 21-0. Okay, Phillips in the shotgun, snap back to him. Looking left this time. Now he's being rushed, throws left. This ball is incomplete off the hands of the intended receiver at the 33-yard line.
He got hit just as soon as he threw the ball, or was getting hit.
Liberty-Eylau through the air, 1 of 5 for 0 yards. They did complete one, but for no gain. And so Liberty-Eylau now will punt for the third time in the ball game from their 28-yard line, this time with 26 seconds left here in the half.
That was Gatlin getting pressure on the quarterback for Liberty-Eylau.
Who's back deep?
26 seconds to see. And this is Colbert. And he's not going to really go back deep. They fake it. And let's see, they will not get the first down.
Oh,
they
man.
Went with the fake and did not get the first down. Flag on the play. Boy, what a risk there by Liberty-Eylau. Now they give us the football at the 32-yard line, depending on this penalty.
They must have had a penalty on us.
Unless we're offside.
Oh, we're offside, okay. So that will make it 4th down and 1.
Scott's not happy about that.
I bet he's not.
You know, we had a few, penalties that kind of hurt us. Had the fumble on the last possession down there inside the 20, and then that, I guess we maybe were expecting, got a little too anxious. But fourth and one.
Fourth down and one for Liberty-Eylau at their 33. High snap for the punter. He comes down with it, gets it off. No one is back deep for Carthage. It hits at the 34 and goes laterally and is down to the 33 with 12.7 seconds left to play in the ball in the first half.
So far, totally dominated by Carthage. Will they have one first down, Larry? Seemed like a
two.
Two.
So Liberty-Eylau with a punt. That was a 34-yarder and no return. Carthage first down and 10 at our 33. And we're going to go into what sometimes we call the victory formation when you've got the game wrapped up. But this is just to make sure that we don't turn it over here. Kason Davis takes it, goes to a knee for a 2-yard loss. That's the end of the half. Carthage 21, Liberty-Eylau nothing.
Panola County relies on ETMC Carthage for high-quality care from medical professionals you know and trust. We offer a full range of services, like 24-hour emergency and level 4 trauma care, diagnostics including 64-slice CT, MRI, digital mammography, bone density, ultrasound, and X-ray, and ETMC First Physicians Clinics with specialists in pediatrics and family health. ETMC is proud to be one with East Texas.
The city of Carthage, county seat of Panola County, gas capital of the United States, and friendliest spot in the world. We have it all: temperate weather, lots of jobs, good schools and churches, and even the Texas Country Music Hall of Fame. Carthage, a great spot on Highway 59 to settle down or just to visit for a while. Panola College, local medical care, a low tax base, and great shopping. That's Carthage. Recommend us, refer us, and revive yourself in the piney woods of East Texas. Carthage, with places we're all proud to call home.
Are you experiencing sickness, fighting a toothache, or just need someone to vent your frustrations to? Stop by the Hope Project in downtown Tenaha for all your medical, dental, and mental health needs. They accept Medicaid, Medicare, and most major insurance plans and offer a sliding fee discount for those who qualify. The Hope Project is now a designated site to offer counseling assistance with the healthcare marketplace. For a healthier East Texas, come see the Hope Project or call 936-248-HOPE.
Randy Hudson, a 1984 Carthage High School graduate, invites you to stop by their Carthage branch of the Hudson Financial Group. They offer property and casualty insurance on an individual platform, which allows them to help you with all types of risk with companies like the Hartford, Mass Mutual, and Travelers, to just name a few. Randy and his dad, Herb, look forward to assisting you with your insurance and financial needs. The Hudson Financial Group, 1507 West Panola in Carthage, 903-693-7874.
When you think of high school football in Texas, you think Carthage Bulldogs. When you think of banking, you should think Prosperity Bank. The Carthage Bulldogs have the strength, leadership, desire, and spirit to obtain another state championship. Prosperity Bank has those same attributes to serve your banking needs. We offer deposit accounts, debit cards, internet and mobile banking, mobile deposit, iPay, as well as consumer, commercial, and residential lending. We can service your needs wherever you are. Stop by the Carthage office and we will share with you our Bulldog spirit. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Well, we have the band director, assistant band director up here, Wade Hull. Wade, you'll have to announce your band director, your assistants.
All right.
And tell us what's all going on with the band.
Well, the band is, the head director of the band program is Nick Durham. And then, like you said, I'm the assistant at the high school. And then we have Desmond Johnson, who is the head middle school director, and the assistant at the junior high is Michelle King, who has returned to us this year.
Okay, but you've got the flag girls out.
We have our
Bulldog
senior,
Bales.
Our senior and captain is Cassie Tinkle of the Majorettes, and the junior and lieutenant is Kelly Sandage. Our flags were led onto the field by senior and captain Chantavia Hicks and sophomore and lieutenant Denisa Leary. They're performing Let It Whip for the band is performing Let It Whip for the drill team and the auxiliary. Well, we have our drum major this year is Riley Green. She's leading the directing the band on the field. And we're also standing outside in our brand new uniforms this year. We have a new West Point military uniform. We have red jackets with a black front and a black collar with a white trim. We also have black trousers with a red stripe going down the center outer leg. And we have black shakos with a red trim around a red band around them and the peace eagle on the front. And of course we have white cross belts. The band's retreating right now back to the field after they played for the auxiliary, and they'll come back out and perform what will be our UIL show this year.
Score is 21-0, Carthage at half. Carthage band's starting their performance.
So they watch, they're marching out, and they're going to do a staggered halt into a chevron in the center of the field, centered on the 50. And our drum major is leading down the 50 to go to the sideline. We have about 14 tubas out there in the middle. And then we'll be beginning with our fanfare, which is Triumph Fanfare. Second song is going to be Boys of the Brigade, Boys of the Old Brigade. And we expand the chevron. Then the chevron marches towards center of the field, to form a block about 12 rows wide. Exit through a cross through. They're marching left to right towards the end zone, and right before they get to the end zone, they do alternate left flanks and form five rows, five columns. The entire band takes a left flank towards the back, towards the other side of the field. They're marching from right to left. Gate swings in the back, and in the front we are doing step twos. We're marching to the Trio Ponderoso. Or to say, from the March Ponderoso, we're doing the trio. Gate swings in back turn into pinwheels. Front two columns go march backwards, and the back three columns are marching from left to right across the field. And they sync up together. And they form a big block. They're going to stop right on the 50-yard line. They go about from the 40-yard line to the 40-yard line. Two-step interval block. And they're going to form CHS for the visiting side, which is our side, and finish off with the fight song.
Scores 21-0 Carthage here at half. Carthage band just got through doing their routine. We'll go back and pay some bills.
Pritchard and Abbott Incorporated are evaluating consultants. What does that mean? They appraise minerals, industrial, utility properties, and data services. From their evaluations of a net worth, fair taxes can be levied. Pritchard and Abbott Incorporated doing their part to be a good neighbor and helping our part of the world stay strong and solvent. Pritchard and Abbott Incorporated, evaluating consultants.
This is Mark Harris at Farmer State Bank in Carthage. Did you know Farmer State Bank offers 15, 20, and 30-year fixed-rate mortgages? We will service your loan in-house, and you can make a payment at one of our five full-service locations, Center, Main Bank, and Rough Rider Branch, Carthage, Joaquin, Shelbyville. So come by Farmer State Bank, and let us help you buy the home of your dreams. Farmer State Bank, member FDIC, and equal housing lender. Money.
Oh, her first word.
Mama.
Then, before I knew it...
Mom!
Soccer practice, art club, driver's ed, dating, graduation, 5 years of college. Mom, this is Ted. Wedding bells, and suddenly...
Grandma!
Life fast forwards. Keep up with Texas Farm Bureau Insurance and protection that changes with your auto, home, and life needs. It's the right coverage for any moment, because moments worth covering are never accidents.
For all your insurance needs, come see me, Jenny Morgan, at Panola County Farm Bureau.
Discounts may vary by situation.
If you don't have an oil well, you need to get one. So Ricky and Casey Bagley at Bagley Well Services can help you take care of it. Bagley Well Services is a complete service. Hookups, pipelines, maintenance, backhoe, dozer, and pipe hauling. Bagley Well Service, one call does it all. 903-690-9700. 903-690-9700. Let Bagley Well Services do the work for you.
It's not Tex-Mex, it's Fresh Mex. That's the slogan at Don Juan's in Carthage. Don Juan's open at 10:30 Monday through Sunday and staying open late on Friday and Saturday for your dining convenience. Happy hour Monday through Friday, 2 until 7. Don Juan's, where $5 lunch specials are back. Don't forget, kids eat free with the purchase of an adult meal. Don Juan's, located one block north of the square in downtown Carthage. It's great Mexican food.
Well, we have a complete different style of band out here now.
Yes, the Liberty-Eylau band is what we would call a core style. We're a traditional military-style marching band. So they formed a block shape on the right side of the field. And they're, they're in their summer heat wear. They're wearing khaki shorts and blue T-shirts. So they got about 75 members out there. They're playing for their drill team. Drill team's wearing white suits with black fedoras on top. Actually, the captains wear black. The others are wearing white fedoras. And it's very sparkly and glittery.
Sure is.
Thank you. course, the drill team exits the field and looks like we have our auxiliary who march our show with us, and they have their what you call a flag line marching out to march with the band. Yeah, it's the front ensemble. We call it the pit. So they got plenty of keyboards, or I should say mallet instruments, and they have one electric keyboard. Bass drum, gong, chimes, several little, I call them toys, little small percussion instruments, triangles and wood blocks and stuff like that. Band's just marching out to their first set. This we call some sort of a like a box shape from the 30 around to the other 30. Mostly a single row of students. Drum majors do a salute in the center of the field and run to their podiums. One on the 45, one on the 50, and one on the other 45. Is presenting some visual effects before the beginning of the music. Thank you. finish with a expansion box with their flags on the outside.
Starts 21-0 Carthage at halftime. We'll go back to the home office and pay some bills.
If you need construction done, check with Carlos and Shane Courtney at Courtney Construction Incorporated. They're the best in the business, whether it's pipeline or dirt work or field maintenance or general construction. The Courtneys are well experienced. Give them a call today at 903-694-2911 or stop by 1300 Northeast Loop in Carthage. Courtney Construction Incorporated. When you need it done right, call Courtney Construction. They'll get it done.
Fidelity Communications is ready to turbocharge your internet service with this amazing offer. You can get 125 megabit internet with 6 months of free Wi-Fi for just $79.99 per month for the first year. New Fidelity Communications customers get special pricing on all three different internet packages, ranging from 25 to 125 megabits per second, starting as low as $24.99 per month. Call 1-800-392-8070 or visit us online at fidelitycommunications.com.
The ladies at the Popcorn Place are ready to take care of your floral needs. They offer cut flower arrangements, memorials, and potted plants. If there is a special occasion in the future, such as a birthday or anniversary, or maybe just a special arrangement, let the ladies at the Popcorn Place assist you with your selection. And don't forget that they carry some wonderful gift items like crystal and pottery and have a bridal registry as well. This can all be found at the Popcorn Place on West Panola in Carthage, 903-693-5421.
Well, I'm Frances Hopkins Frazier, and I decided to go to Winkler Place because I was falling, and I was calling my son to come help me. So, therefore, I prayed about it, and Winkler Place came into my mind. God gave me the answer, and I'm in Winkler Place now, and I enjoy living there. I have everything I need. I'm happy at Winkler Place.
No one wants to be involved in a fender bender, but if it happens to you, let Kelly's Collision Center make your car or truck look like new again. Located on Highway 59 North, that's Kelly's Collision Center. Now here are your first half stats. Again, Kelly's Collision Center bringing you the first half statistics. Carthage with 18 first downs. Liberty-Eylau had 2. Carthage on the ground 68 yards, Liberty-Eylau 46. Carthage through the air 17 of 21 for 155 yards. The Leopards were 1 of 5 for 0 yards. So the total yardage, Carthage 223, Liberty-Eylau 46. Turnovers, there was one turnover for Carthage. That was a fumble, very costly one. We fumbled at the Liberty-Eylau 7-yard line. We were about to go in and score late in the first half to make it 28 to nothing with an extra point and turn it over. Penalties. Both teams have been guilty of several in the first half. Carthage 6 for 55, Liberty-Eylau 7 for 74. Carthage did not punt. Liberty-Eylau punted 3 times for a 41-yard average. The scoring, Carthage took the opening kickoff and took 5:59 off the clock, so 1 second short of holding it for half of the first quarter. Scored on a 12-yard pass from Davis to Bowens. Extra point made it 7-0, 6:01 to play in the first. Then a 6-yard TD pass from Kaysen Davis to Josh Gradberg. 11:52 to play in the second quarter, and the score was 14-0. And then with 4:35 to play in the first half, another TD pass again to Bowens, this one 13 yards, and the score is 21-0 at halftime, Carthage over Liberty-Eylau. And let's see, Dustin, if you're in the range, if you have some scores, we'd really be interested in that. And did you get to see the anything in the halftime talk?
Kind of went down there by the dressing room, watched the coaches kind of go over their plan, what they're going to do here in the second half, and then visit with the players. Looked at my phone, I saw where Whitehouse was up on Chapel Hill at halftime 21-7. Henderson was up on Tatum at halftime 23-6. Kilgore was up on Gladewater 21-15. And the score here is a little surprising. Gilmer was only up 27-21 over center at halftime.
All right. Very good. Mark, you have anything?
I just think we played a really, really good ball game in the first half. And if we can keep this up, you know, it's always a good luxury, Larry, when you have a quarterback.
Oh, my.
You've got a quarterback, it makes all the difference in the world. Coaching here is superior. We're prepared, you know. And then if you add a good quarterback on top of that, you got it made.
And he's exceptional so far.
So far what we've seen out of him, he's as good as we've had. Of course, he could blow up tomorrow night. We've been really lucky since Surratt's been here to have such a string of good quarterbacks. And they were really, though, developed by Surratt.
That's right.
I mean, he slowly developed each one and to get him to think into his process. And I've seen him take a chewing down there. You remember we've seen him? Oh, my gosh. You know, Cy told me, he said, man, he prepared me, for in college because he said, man, he stayed on my case. But he said, I'm a better man for it. So, but, yeah. And then you had a good running back. Our running back's 68 yards the first half. Most of that's got to be by him. So, and our offensive line, great protection here in the first half. So, if you got all those elements and you took the wind out of their sails, especially if we'd have scored there and got 28-0.
Mm-hmm.
They do get the ball first.
And let me remind our listeners, because I said it before the ball game started, and I'm not trying to say this would have made a big difference in the ball game, but it is newsworthy, certainly, that the top, the number two ranked defensive end in the country, as far as the recruits are concerned, Legarian Carson from Liberty-Eylau, 6'5", 255, a senior, and committed to the University of Texas. He is no longer on the Liberty-Eylau football team. We do not have any idea what happened there, but he played last week against Gilmer. And he is gone from the team. So he is not suited up tonight. Carthage Bulldogs leading it at halftime 21-0. We're going to take another break before the second half kickoff.
When I picture Panola, I picture opportunity. A chance to pursue my dream of becoming a nurse, one of the fastest growing occupations in the U.S. with the potential to earn up to $82,000 a year. Panola's small class size allows me to receive personalized attention at a cost I can afford, and their state-of-the-art simulation labs allow me to develop excellent nursing skills. I'm excited to jumpstart my nursing career with Panola College. What does Panola College look like for you? Picture your Panola. Visit panola.edu today.
Wing Night in America at your Sonic in Carthage. Bringing you the second half kickoff. Wing Night in America at your Sonic in Carthage, Monday through Thursday. After 5 p.m., wings are half price. Explore the six different flavors at Sonic in Carthage. The Bulldogs getting ready to kick off here in the second half. They'll be kicking off from our right to left, and here's a high short kick. They come up and take it at the 21 to the 25, going left now to the 30-yard line. Looked like he bobbled it just before he went out of bounds, and he steps out of bounds at the Liberty-Eylau 31. So Liberty-Eylau getting the football first here in the second half, going from our left to right.
Yes, he did juggle that ball. That ball came above his head in the air, but he re-caught it. Kudos to the defense. Defense played a heck of a first half. Two first downs given up. This team put 55 points last week on Gilman.
All right, let's see who they're going to go with quarterback. They're going to stay with DeCorian Phillips. In the backfield with him is Kevin Florence, who was their leading rusher last week. Snap back to Phillips. Flag on the play. False start.
We did a shift on the defensive line that caused one of their linemen to jump off sides.
I think it was actually the running back took a little bit of a head start. But, you know, this is a whole new half, and we got to come out here with the same mentality and intensity that we did in the first half. Continue that strong performance on defense we had in the first half and keep clicking on offense like we did in the first half.
So that moves it back 5 yards to the 26. It's now first and 15 for Liberty-Eylau. Hand off to Florence. Florence over the right side. And he's going to get the 5 that they lost on the penalty and one more. Well, he's going to pick up four of the five that they lost on the penalty after the 30-yard line. Second down and 11 now for Liberty-Eylau. And we've got
the running back is down. He had Gatlin fall on top of him when he hit the ground. So, let's see. He got up, but he may have to leave the game since he didn't make him stop. Yes.
Okay, Florence is the young man that was down on the ground, and he picked up 4 yards on that play for the five they lost on the penalty. So it's second and 11 now for Liberty-Eylau at their 30. Phillips is the quarterback. Livingston with him in the backfield. Hand off to Livingston. Livingston going left and is out of bounds. Or no, he stayed in bounds but was tackled at the 35-yard line. A gain of five for Livingston.
I think it was Ashton Hicks coming up from a safety position and putting a stick on him. Open field tackle. Good tackle there. 21-0, Carthage.
They're probably not going to kick. I mean, they probably will kick if they don't pick up a first down here on this third down. Third down and six at their 35. 11 minutes to play in the third. Phillips in the shotgun. High snap. He comes down with it. Hands off to Livingston. Livingston needed six, and he gets two after the 37. Make that one. And they will now face fourth down and five, and here comes their punting unit.
Our blitz, we had a blitz going on, had all the gaps filled and stopped him with a short gain.
Another good job there by the defense. Defensive line has really done a good job tonight. Linebacker play has been great as well.
So the line of scrimmage is the 36, and they'll be punting for the fourth time here in the ball game. Makai Colbert standing back at the Carthage 34. Waist-high snap. Nice kick. Colbert retreats, takes it at the 25, going right to the 30, and is stopped at the 33. Considering he was the only one back, pretty good return of 8 yards out to the 33-yard line.
Well, when you have a good kick like that was, it stays in the air. It gives the defense time to pursue and get nothing but purple was standing there waiting on him. He's surprised he got his 5 yards he got.
So Carthage takes over at their 34. If you've just joined us, Carthage leading at 21-0. We had a turnover late in the first half that would have made it 28-0. Carthage dominating in the first half with 18 first downs, two for Liberty-Eylau. And Carthage takes over now at their 34, ball on the right hash. And this is going to be Kaysen Davis under center. This time we've got DeWaylon Ingram and Callaway split out to the left. Keontae Ingram is the tailback. Play action fake. Davis wants to throw it. Going deep. Has a man out there, Callaway. This ball is caught at the 15. It's going to be a touchdown for Roderick Callaway, and he dances into the end zone. A 66-yard touchdown pass. This Carthage Bulldog touchdown made possible by the Bulldog Stop, where you can find Exxon Gas plus the best snacks in town.
Boy, had plenty of time and just threw a bomb. Hit him in stride. Guy tried to tackle him, couldn't. He walked on into the end zone. Bulldogs strike first here in the second half. Great pass.
Beautiful pass.
Yeah, I thought it might be just a little bit underthrown for the defender to get back and tip it away, but Roderick Callaway, he's so tall and he can jump and good hands. He kind of went up and, you know, got it in front of the defender.
United Methodist Church extra point is good, and the score is Carthage 28, Liberty-Eylau nothing. 9:49 to play in the third. Back right after this.
If you need construction done, check with Carlos and Shane Courtney at Courtney Construction Incorporated. They're the best in the business, whether it's pipeline or dirt work or field maintenance or general construction. The Courtneys are well experienced. Give them a call today at 903-694-2911 or stop by 1300 Northeast Loop in Carthage. Courtney Construction Incorporated. When you need it done right, call Courtney Construction. They'll get it done.
Fidelity Communications is ready to turbocharge your internet service with this amazing offer. You can get 125 megabit internet with 6 months of free Wi-Fi for just $79.99 per month for the first year. New Fidelity Communications customers get special pricing on all three different internet packages, ranging from 25 to 125 megabits per second, starting as low as $24.99 per month. Call 1-800-392-8070 or visit us online at fidelitycommunications.com.
Kason Davis let that one fly. It went, according to my numbers, about 57 yards in the air. It is a 66-yard touchdown pass. Carthage now up 28-0. Here's a kickoff taken at the 22, a low line drive kick, and they're going to return it out across the 35 to the 36. Liberty-Eylau first and 10 there at their 36-yard line. Okay, Dustin, got to ask you about this. How is D. Bowens?
I think he's fine. I saw him after right before halftime. He was sitting on the bench. He's over there walking right now toward the bench to get some water. So I think he's all right. I think he may have just got the breath knocked out of him on that one pass play.
All right. Liberty-Eylau with it now, first and 10 at their 36-yard line. Phillips still in there at quarterback. Snap back to him. Handoff goes to Huff. Huff up the middle, and then he is met by a couple of Bulldogs and stopped at the 39. 3-yard pickup, second and 7 coming up.
That was McHale coming up out of there. McHale Gates coming up out of his middle linebacker position, put the tag on him after a small gain. They just not been able to run the ball on us, and that's their forte.
Second and 7 now for Liberty-Eylau at their 39-yard line. Hand off to the running back coming to the right this time, and he has one of their better gains of the night. It's going to be out to the 45-yard line, a gain of 6. It'll be third down and 1.
Austin Russell on the tackle from his defensive line position. I didn't really realize that how big he was, Russell.
Third down and 1 for Eylau now at their 45. And here's the quarterback going to keep it, Phillips, after a play-action fake. He's down the sideline, 40, 35. This is their biggest gain of the night as he is run out of bounds at the 28-yard line. That's going to be a nice gain for them. First down.
Yeah, well, just good play on their part. He faked the handoff to the running back. We bit on the running back. He cut up field.
Yeah, they're going to hurry up, and we had a linebacker blitz on that left side, and that's right where he ran.
28 yards. And here's a handoff, and it's going to be a loss on the play. That's going to be a loss of about 1 yard.
That's too tall Jones out there, Gatlin. He made the tackle himself, caused him to retreat in the backfield and then got a hold to him. He's so long, like Dustin says.
Okay, 2-yard loss takes it back to the 29-yard line. Second down and 12 for Liberty-Eylau at the Carthage 29. 8:05 left to play in the third quarter. Carthage leading 28-0. Phillips in the shotgun gets the snap. Play action fake. He wants to throw it. Throws it right. This ball is caught at the 21 to the 20. And tackle from behind and brought down at the 19-yard line. It's not going to be a first down. It will be a gain of about 8 on that pass play.
Well, you see, when you have a little success running, then you get to play action. And that's what happened then. They play actioned us. And they had a man out in flat open.
And at last, with 7:35 left to play in the third quarter, they have positive passing yards in the ball game. Third down and 2. Here's a handoff to Hoof. Hoof going to his left, has a first down at the 15 and stopped at the 14. That will be a first down after a gain of 5, and they have a first down. They're fourth of the ball game.
And don't forget, they scored a bunch of points last week on Gilmer in the second half.
First and 10 now for Liberty-Eylau at the Carthage 14 as they try to break this shutout here. Phillips in the shotgun, snap back to him. Phillips, play action fake, throws to the right. This ball is caught in the end zone for a touchdown. 14-yard touchdown pass by Liberty-Eylau, and they are now on the scoreboard with 7:06 left to play in the third quarter. It's Carthage 28 and Liberty-Eylau 6.
Well, that was pretty good drive on their part.
Here's a flag as they line up in the swinging gate.
Too many men on the field.
Too many men on the field, okay.
Man was trying to run off. But
yeah, we were on those two, pass plays on the last three plays for Liberty-Eylau. We were actually playing a little soft there in the secondary and opened up those little 10 to 15 yard open areas in their secondary, and that's where they completed the passes.
So they're going to attempt the extra point now from the 15 yard line, so the equivalent of a 25 yard field goal attempt. There's the snap. Pretty good rush by Carthage, and they're going to go now for 2. They go into the end zone, and it's overthrown That was a fake, and they went for two. Incomplete pass in the end zone. Carthage up 28-6, 7:06 to play.
The ladies at the Popcorn Place are ready to take care of your floral needs. They offer cut flower arrangements, memorials, and potted plants. If there is a special occasion in the future, such as a birthday or anniversary, or maybe just a special arrangement, let the ladies at the Popcorn Place assist you with your selection. And don't forget that they carry some wonderful gift items like crystal and pottery and have a bridal registry as well. This can all be found at the Popcorn Place on West Panola in Carthage, 903-693-5421.
Well, I'm Frances Hopkins Frazier, and I decided to go to Winkler Place because I was falling, and I was calling my son to come help me. So, therefore, I prayed about it, and Winkler Place came into my mind. God gave me the answer, and I'm in Winkler Place now, and I enjoy living there. I have everything I need. I'm happy at Winkler Place.
Liberty-Eylau kicking off, and they do kick it deep. We're going to come up and take it at the 15. We fumble it, pick it back up now to the 20. This is Callaway to the 25, and dropped at the 26-yard line, 26 or 27. Carthage will have it there. 6:59 to play in the third. Carthage up 28-6.
Well, you know, we the first half, we kept their offense off the field, and that has a lot to do with their score. We need to have a time-consuming drive here. .6:59 left in the third quarter, 28-6 Carthage.
So Carthage starts this drive at their 27, going toward the west end zone here at Harris Field in the third quarter. Ball is on the right hash. Davis in the shotgun with two receivers to the left, one to the right. Ingram in the backfield now goes motion right. Here's Davis wanting to throw left. He throws. This ball is caught. Great catch there. Diving catch by DeWaylon Ingram for a 9-yard reception out to the 36-yard line.
That was a pretty good pass. It kept it low where it couldn't be knocked into the air or anything. So, 9-yard gain.
Second down and one for Carthage at the 36-yard line. I might have detected a slight limp there for Kaysen Davis. Davis under center. Handoff goes to Ingram. Ingram left side to the 40 and pushed out of bounds at the 40 after a 4-yard gain, and that would be another Garrett's record service Bulldog first down.
Yeah, he got to the outside and got enough for a first down. We're just waiting for him to take that plant step like Dustin says and go north and south. When we do, we may see how fast he really is. 6:13, third quarter. 28-6 Carthage.
I think Kaysen Davis may have just the slightest limp there. First and 10 for Carthage at the 40. Play action fake. Kaysen rolling to his right. Wants to throw it over the middle. It's complete to Gradberg across the midfield marker. Another Garrett's record service all the way down to the ILO 39-yard line.
He did a bootleg out, rolled out, and had a choice of Bowen or Gradberg. Found Gradberg at the stripes there. Gradberg, I loved it. He put both hands on the ball and started running north and south. They
yeah,
that fumble.
Our play action, our bootlegs have worked real well for us tonight.
So the first down goes to the ILO 39-yard line. Well, if Kaysen was limping in, he didn't look like it on that scramble out to the right. Kaysen under center now. Twins to the right, one to the left. Here's the handoff to Ante Ingram. Ingram to the 35, 30, still on his feet, dancing back to the left now to the 25-yard line, to the 20, to the 15, down to the 11-yard line. Another Garrett's record service Bulldog first down after a 28-yard run by Keontae Ingram.
Wow, we got a flag, though. Probably going to be holding downfield is what I'm guessing. But he was turning and juking, and they have a timeout by the referee. 5:25 left third quarter, 28-6, but we're threatening again. They did give up 61 points last week, so their defense is suspect to give up some points. So we got somebody down. We got somebody down on the field.
That's going to be 17 yards for Keontae Ingram.
They got somebody on the field. We'll be back after this.
When I picture Panola, I picture opportunity. A chance to pursue my dream of becoming a nurse, one of the fastest growing occupations in the U.S. with the potential to earn up to $82,000 a year. Panola's small class size allows me to receive personalized attention at a cost I can afford, and their state-of-the-art simulation labs allow me to develop excellent nursing skills. I'm excited to jumpstart my nursing career with Panola College. What does Panola College look like for you? Picture your Panola. Visit panola.edu today.
At Panola National Bank, we're constantly looking for ways to make community banking even better. Now we're making it easier for you to bank on the go with Mobile PNB. Our new mobile banking service allows you to access your accounts directly from your cell phone so you can make transfers, check balances, and search transactions all from the convenience of your cell phone or tablet. Be sure to check out our new free mobile apps in the iTunes Store and the Google Play Store. Panola National Bank, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
Well, the injured player for Liberty-Eylau is Caleb Jones, and he limped off the field. Hate to see that. It's some type of a leg injury. 17-yard gain for Ingram, then a 10-yard penalty for the Bulldogs. A net gain of 7. It is now first and three at the 32-yard line. First down and three. Davis in the shotgun. Snack back to Kaysen. Play action fake. Throwing right. This ball is caught there. By Bowens at the 30. Bowens inside the 25. Another Garrett's record service Bulldog first down inside the 25-yard line.
Boy, he's quick as a cat. He did a couple of jukes then and then dove forward and did not get hit.
And that's fine.
Yeah. We are moving the ball without a fumble. We would probably be ahead in this game 35-6 right now.
First down and 10 for Carthage at the Liberty-Eylau 23. Moving it down the field and taking time off the clock. 4:45 left to play in this ball in the third quarter. 4:45 in the third. Carthage up 28-6. Here's Davis under center, handoff to Keontae Ingram, going to his right to the 20 and pushed out of bounds at the 20 after picking up 3 yards.
Yeah, he cut to the outside and then just basically ran out of bounds. They're listening to me out at Jeter Junction. My cronies. 4:36.
Oh, wait a minute. There's a flag down at the 5-yard line.
Okay. The play wasn't, there wasn't nobody over here at all.
I think this line just threw that flag from all the way what happened downfield blocking at about our 5-yard line on our sideline. It's a long way to throw a flag. On the other side of the field.
Yeah, because the play was on the other side. A little sloppy, but that's expected. This is really our first game. Last week we had a rain delay and a lightning delay, and then we lost all the power. So how far are we moving it back here? The line of scrimmage?
Yeah, it's from the line of scrimmage. Actually, he marked off 11. Okay, an 11-yard penalty. And it goes from the 23 out to the 34. And so that makes it now first and 21. First and 21 for the Bulldogs at their 30 at the Liberty-Eylau 34-yard line. 4:30 left to play in the third quarter. Carthage up 28-6. Davis in the shotgun. Snap back to him. Davis. Wants to go with a screen pass. Now flushed out of the pocket. Rolling to his right, and he takes the sack. And to avoid a possible interception, that's going to be a loss on the sack of about 3 yards. It is back to the 37.
Yeah, he needs to slide in on that deal to keep somebody from hitting him.
Well, we were going to run the screen out of the backfield to Keontae, and Liberty-Eylau recognized it's all covered up. And he did the smart thing of running, but, you know, and sliding down, he probably should have just thrown it out of bounds. Just 3 yards.
That would have been the better call right there. So now it's second. Let's see. It's on the 37, and we've got to get down to the 13. So it's second down at about 34.
Old D. Bowens will get it back right here.
24 yards to go. Snap back to Davis in the shotgun. Heavy pressure and sack back at the midfield marker. Boy, they came with pressure there. At least one man got through. And that's going to be a big loss there.
Blitz.
That's a 12-yard loss. That is their biggest defensive play for certain in the ball game. And Carthage all the way back now to the Liberty-Eylau 49-yard line. And again, must reach the 13, so it's third and 36.
Third and a five wood.
And we just now have gone under the three-minute mark, so taking some time off the clock on this drive, even though we have sputtered here in the last couple of plays. 3 seconds on the play clock. Two, one, and barely get it off. Davis looking left, looking left, and he throws it downfield. This ball is incomplete, almost picked off by one of the Leopards, and it'll be fourth and 36 now at the Liberty-Eylau 49.
I know you don't want an interception on your record, but it would have been nice if he'd have got an interception there. It would have been down almost as good as a punt. 2:39 left, third quarter, 28-6 Dogs.
All right, we're going to kick it, and we've got two punters. Mason Graham, who is the deep snapper when Kaysen Davis is punting, and Davis is back to kick on this one. 15-yard drop. Line of scrimmage is the Liberty-Eylau 49. They had one man back deep. Here's the kick, and it's going to be, they're going to take it on a diving catch at the 22-yard line, and that's where Liberty-Eylau will have it first and 10.
Now, last time they got the ball, they had a pretty good drive. We need to, this game is by far not over, but we're 22 ahead, but still, stranger things have happened. We gave them a little life.
So Liberty-Eylau now first and 10 at their 22. Quarterback is going to be DeCorian Phillips again. And Florence, who was injured earlier, is back in there. Handoff goes to Hoof. Hoof going to the left and brought down for a loss there. That's going to be a loss of one back to the 21-yard line.
We had two there. I think he just slipped, but we had two ball players there.
So a loss of one, second and 11, 2:10 left to play here in the third. Carthage up 28-6. Phillips again in the shotgun, and here's a play action fake. He's going to throw it to the right, throw it to the near sideline, and incomplete. Their own coverage for Carthage was Nick Moore.
Yeah, we made him throw a little early, and he threw it over the head. You can just tell when you got a polished quarterback throwing the ball, as we have been shown so far this year, is tough for a team that does not have a polished quarterback to play a full game.
Second down and 11 now. Third and 11, make that. Third and 11 for Liberty-Eylau at the 21-yard line, and Liberty-Eylau calls the timeout. We'll take a break here.
This is Walter Sparks with XL Ford Lincoln Mercury here in Carthage, encouraging y'all to come out and see our large inventory of new cars, trucks, and SUVs. We have rebates up to $8,000 on selected models, a good selection of pre-owned cars and trucks at very affordable prices, financing available with excellent service and parts. Check out our website, XL Ford of Carthage, for updates on a regular basis. Remember, we're still on the South Loop, and we're still number one. God bless America and Semper Fi.
At Carthage Furniture, Monty Bacon and his staff have a deal for you. A sofa and love seat in dark brown or tan, your choice. Now add three tables and two beautiful lamps, and it's yours for just $7.99. That's a sofa, love seat, three tables, two lamps, yours for $7.99. Or check this out, a red or brown love seat and sofa for $9.68. Speak Spanish? Monty can help. Carthage Furniture on West Panola in Carthage.
All right, trips to the right for Liberty-Eylau. Here's Phillips. He wants to throw it. Now he's being pressured, rolling to his left. Running room, 25-30, has a first down and steps out of bounds. Flag. Here comes a flag in. Steps out at the 35-yard line.
Going to be a block in the back on Liberty-Eylau.
Does that go? Is that a spot foul? Does he get
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. 1:53 left third quarter, 28-6 Carthage. That was a clear block in the black, way out in the middle of the field. You know. it's a holding call on them. Well, no. They're still showing third down. I thought I saw them go.
Yeah, they get a 10-yard penalty there. But they also get the, they get the result of the run.
Apparently not, because it still shows third
14.
Down. That was a first down.
Yard.
Screen.
Here's another pass, screen pass to the right side, out to the 20, 25, 30, 35-yard line, and that's going to be a first down for him.
We pushed him down, and he fell for a first down. Pushed him from behind. He gained 5 yards on that. So a minute 40 left in the third quarter, 28-6 Carthage.
All right, here's the next play, and it is a handoff out to the 39-yard line. Could be a gain of 4 on that play.
Russell on the tackle with Gates, and Gatlin helped clean it up.
1:20 left to go now in the third quarter. Liberty-Eylau leading at 28-6.
No, Carthage.
It's Carthage, pardon me. Carthage up 28-6. Second down and 6. Here's a throw to the left. It's caught there, and he's going to be stopped after a gain of about 1 yard to the 40-yard line. So Liberty-Eylau is going to have it third down and 5 at their 40.
Good job there, Mike. Makai Cover getting off the block, and Jace Dixon coming over his outside linebacker spot making the tackle.
50 seconds left in the third quarter. They got trips over here.
Three receivers to the right, one to the left. Third down and 5, 42 seconds left to play. Here's Phillips, option to the left side, and he keeps it and picks up a first down across midfield. And it's going to go from the Carthage 40 to the, excuse me, from the Liberty-Eylau 40, pardon me, to the Carthage 47, a gain of 13 for Phillips. That is a first down for them.
Just about every time that he's carried it tonight, he's done well, because we're not accounting for it.
First down and 10 from the 47 of Carthage. Here's a handoff, and they're down to the 41-yard line, a gain of 6. And that's going to bring us to the end of the third quarter, I believe, unless they snap it in a hurry.
They need as many snaps as they can get.
Gain of 7 will make it. Second down and 3 from the 40. They throw to the right side, caught there at the 43, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20. Stays on the 15, 10, 5, and out of bounds inside the 5-yard line. It's going to be a gain from the 41 on a pass play as he tightroped down the near sideline.
And that's the end of the third quarter.
That's the end of the third quarter. All right, end of 3. Carthage up 28-6, but Liberty-Eylau on the move. Back right after this.
Here at First State Bank and Trust Company, we know that life can get busy. Since banking is a necessary part of life, but not always a productive use of your day, we're pleased to offer mobile deposit to make depositing checks faster and easier. Using an improved mobile device with internet access, mobile deposit allows you to snap a picture of the front and the back of your check, and then submit the check securely to your account, giving you more time to spend on the things that matter. Serving East Texas since 1902, First State Bank and Trust Company, Carthage.
Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
September is kicking off. We got up to 20% off on select GMC half-ton pickups 2016 models. We got up to 16% off on select 2016 Silverado models, not to mention 0% for 72 months on all 2016 Chevrolet models. Excluding your base entry value packages. So come see us. We're Pippin Motor Company. We're located across from Panola College or on the web at pippinmotorcompany.com.
Okay, that play went all the way to the 1-yard line. I thought he was knocked out at the 6, but it's going to be first and goal for Liberty-Eylau from the Carthage 1 as we start the fourth quarter. Carthage up 28-6. And the handoff to Hoof. Hoof up the middle. And he's in. 1-yard touchdown run for DeAndre Hoof. And it's now 28-12 Carthage as they score on the first play of the fourth quarter.
They pretty much need to go for 2 here.
Yeah, they're kind of spreading it out a little bit more, and they're going to throw the ball, and I think they really have to get back in this game. The run game has been good at times but not consistent, so they're definitely going for 2 here.
All right, they will go for 2. Phillips, the quarterback, going to be in the shotgun. Levingston with him in the backfield, trips to the right. One of them goes motion left. Here's Levingston rolling to his right, throws into the end zone. This ball is caught for the two-point conversion. And the score now is Carthage 28, Liberty-Eylau 14, getting ready for the kickoff. We'll be back right after this.
President Harry S. Truman once said, "If men and nations would but live by the precepts of the ancient prophets and the teachings of the Sermon on the Mount, problems which now seem so difficult would soon disappear." Hi, this is Dennis Smith, inviting you to come and worship with us, Central Baptist Church in Carthage. On Sunday, our services are at 9:30 a.m. and 10:45 a.m. If you can't come, tune us in on KGAS 103.7 FM or KGAS 1590 a.m. We are also on Fidelity Cable Channel 18. May God bless you.
Panola County relies on ETMC Carthage for high-quality care from medical professionals you know and trust. We offer a full range of services, like 24-hour emergency and level 4 trauma care, diagnostics, including 64-slice CT, MRI, digital mammography, bone density, ultrasound, and X-ray, and ETMC First Physicians Clinics with specialists in pediatrics and family health. ETMC is proud to be one with East Texas.
This is where you kind of look for an onside. You kind of got back in the yep. game, and you know.
Carthage looking for the onside kick here. 28-14 Carthage. If you have just joined us, Carthage, after they scored early in the third quarter, led 28-0. Liberty-Eylau has come back with two unanswered touchdowns to make it 28-14. He's going to kick it deep, and we take it back at the 9, coming up to the 10, 15, 20. Going left now. This is Colbert, 25, 30, and upended at the 32-yard line. Pretty good return there by Makai Colbert. He gets up a little slow, but I think he's going to be okay.
We just need to play the game we've been playing all night. You know, run, get pass, run, time off the clock. That's all you got to do here.
So the Bulldogs will take over at their 32. Again, 13 seconds into the fourth quarter, and the Carthage lead of 28-0 early in the fourth. We led 28-0 early in the third. It's now 28-14. Davis in the shotgun. Snap back to Kaysen. Big rush on him. Throws left to Ingram. Lots of running room. 30, 35, 40. And a Garrett's record service Bulldog first down. Out across the 40-yard line.
Just keep doing what we've been doing the whole ball game. They really haven't stopped us but one drive all night. We fumbled on the inside the 10 for our other stop. Just keep diversifying your offense here.
Okay, that was an 11-yard pickup there on the pass to Keontae Ingram. Carthage 271 yards through the air now. First and 10 at our 43. Clock is moving. Handoff goes to Keontae Ingram. Ingram brought down after a gain of one. Buttholes onto the football.
We had a trap play then, and our lead blocker didn't block anybody. And so he had really nowhere to go.
Yeah, our lead blocker got in the hole. There wasn't no one there. He was looking for somebody. Then another defensive lineman got off the block and was able to make the tackle right there in the hole. It was there, but just posed up quick with another defensive lineman.
Second down 9 now for Carthage at the Carthage 44. 10:45 to go in the game. Carthage up 28-14. Needing to pick up first downs here and run clock. Davis in the shotgun. 4 seconds on the play clock. Now down to 2. Snap with 2. Here's Davis looking to pass. He's going to throw deep down the near sideline. Going to be interference, and it's going to be incomplete pass, but they were holding Callaway, and this should be interference against Liberty-Eylau.
Should be, because he hit him by the jersey. He's jerking him down, you know.
If that's not interference, I don't know what it is.
Yeah, it was interference clearly. I mean, he was going to go for a touchdown is what he's fixed to do because he was broken free.
Oh, they're going to call it against Callaway.
Wow, he must have done the infraction before we saw the pass go.
Wow.
Well, 10:25 left.
Boy, I'd like to see that one over again.
been a 15 yard.
That's 15.
It must have been something else. That must have been a personal.
No,
foul.
It was interference. That's what he signaled. 15 wow. yard penalty. All right, moves it back to the Carthage 29 now. Second and very long. Here's a flag. Davis under a rush and is tackled. I think that's going to be Liberty-Eylau offside there.
I don't know. They let the play run. So that was a false start. Is they don't let the play run.
No, it's offside against Liberty-Eylau.
Okay. We just need to keep the ball in our hands. You can't lose.
That's a good policy right there. Keep it in our hands. Second down, the ball is now at the Carthage 34. And it is second down and 19. Second and 19 for Carthage at our 34. 10-12 and counting to go here in the ball game. Carthage up 28-14. 6 seconds on the play clock. Davis in the shotgun. Twins to each side. Snap back to Kaysen. Kaysen looking left. Heavy pressure now. And he's going to be sacked. Flag comes in back at the 25-yard line.
Well, that was a coverage sack. It's got to be because he had plenty of time.
Yeah, holding on up. Just getting a little sloppy here and making some mistakes when it hurts us the most. And we're going backwards instead of forward. We get a little bit of momentum going forwards and we have a mistake and it goes backwards. They decline the penalty.
So a loss of 8. They decide to take the play wisely instead of the penalty. 9:51 to go in the ball game. And it is now third down. The ball's on the 26. We've got to get to their 47. So that's 27 yards to go. Third and 27 for Carthage from our 26. Kaysen Davis in the shotgun. He wants to throw. Pressured. Throws. It is caught by Callaway. At the 44.
That's good.
Short of a first down, but it picks up a bunch of those yards.
That's a field position changer right there, especially if we decide to punt. That gives us quite a few yards up the field.
That was an 18-yard pickup on that pass play to Callaway. 4th down and 9. Now remember, Kaysen Davis can kick it. We're going for it, evidently, at our 44-yard line.
He's offsides.
And Davis rolling to his right. And he runs out of bounds.
That's not good
at
either.
The 37-yard line. There is a flag on the play.
That's offsides them. That'll give us 5 more yards. 9:30 left, 28-14 Carthage. The momentum has slowly shifted to Liberty-Eylau. But they are committing penalties.
Okay, Liberty-Eylau was offside, so instead of being 4th and 9, now it will be 4th and 4.
Time for one of them bootlegs.
Now, you remember when we needed 30-something yards? Now we only need 4. 4th and 4, we're evidently going for it at our 49-yard line. 12 seconds left on the play clock. I think we're trying to draw them offside, and it's not working. 5 seconds to go on the play clock. 4, 3, snap back to Davis. Davis, here comes a big rush. Throw down the field for Bowens, and it's incomplete. And Liberty-Eylau will take over on downs. And Kaysen Davis slow to get up.
Yeah, we didn't have good blocking there and didn't even give Kaysen a chance to get his feet set and throw the ball. Like you said, the moment is now in Liberty-Eylau's favor.
Thank goodness we got 14 ahead.
So the Bulldogs, 4th and 4 from our 49, went for it. Pass was incomplete. Now Liberty-Eylau, who has scored on the last couple of possessions to cut it to a 2-touchdown ball game, they've got it back now. Here's Phillips. They're going to go with a halfback pass. Here's Lawrence throwing it downfield up in the air, and this ball is incomplete. We had great coverage downfield. We had 2-on-1 coverage downfield on that halfback pass, and it's incomplete.
Yeah, we should have probably had an interception there. We were facing the play, unless that defender knocked it away. I mean, the offensive man, I couldn't tell.
All right, here's another play. And I must admit, I was watching the sideline on an injury, and I didn't see what happened. What was the play, Mark?
It was a pitch out to the running back to the right, and we bottled it up pretty good.
That was a flag. It looked like it's going to be holding on Liberty-Eylau.
9:09 left in the game, 28-14 Carthage.
I was looking on the Carthage bench for a possible injury situation, and it is going to be a flag against the Leopards. And that's going to take them back 10 yards to their 41.
You know, Gates is coming off. Brewster Griffith taking his spot. Looked like he may be cramping a little bit.
Yeah, I noticed at the end of the third quarter he was walking ginger.
Gosh, if we had a bunch of penalties this game. Carthage 9 for 91. Liberty-Eylau 12 for 108. Snap back to Phillips. Phillips wants to throw it. Throwing it left. This ball is incomplete. And Nick Moore took down the intended receiver as he went up in the air to try to come down with it.
A little bit of pressure, and Gatlin out there tall made him throw that ball high. Stops the clock with 8:56.
Now it's third down and 20. Third and 20 for Liberty-Eylau at their 41. 8:56, as Mark said, left to go. Carthage up 28-14.
Big play right here for the defense. You step up.
Yeah.
Third down and 20. Phillips going to be in the shotgun again. Two receivers to each side for Liberty-Eylau. Snap back to Phillips. He wants to go with a screen pass. They catch it at the 40. Gets loose to the 45. Midfield. 45. Stood on his feet. 40. Big play for Liberty-Eylau. Third and 20, and they're going to pick up a first down and keep the football.
Not good tackling.
No.
We had him stop.
Yeah, we had him stop. Start of this play.
Got to wrap him up. He's their bigger back. He's not the smaller one.
24-yard gain. We had him stop there.
Need a turnover.
Phillips with it now. Throws to the left. It's caught there by Isaiah Cross, their other quarterback, and he stopped
great play.
A very short gain.
Julian made a great play. Threw off the block and made the tackle out there in open field. And the clock remains running.
No gain on that play, so it's second down and 10 now for Liberty-Eylau at the Carthage 35. 8:15 to go in the ball game. Carthage leading at 28-14. Second and 10 at the Dog 35. Phillips hands off to the running back. Running back going ahead. Livingston to the left now, and he is cut down at the 23-yard line, or he might have scored on that play. 12-yard pickup, another first down for Liberty-Eylau.
8:02 left. 28-14 Carthage. Brewster Griffith enters the game for Gates. They're back.
Phillips in the shotgun again. Hands off the running back, going to the left this time, 20, 15, and is down at the 14-yard line, make it the 15, a gain of 7 on the play.
If they do score here, we're going to have to make them take some time to score. 7:35 left.
Okay, gain of 8 to the 15-yard line.
Our defense is tired.
Yeah, they got confused, too. They've been passing ball and having success.
Phillips with it now. Hands off. Running back going left this time. This is Livingston. Flag on the play, and he's going to be stopped after a gain of about 2.
There's a flag. It's a holding, I think. Unless it's a face mask in the open field out there or something. Holding Liberty-Eylau. So that's going to make them second and long. 7:17 is the time left.
Boy, when you want that clock to run, it sure doesn't seem like it runs very fast.
No.
Okay, that takes it back now to the 25-yard line. Second down and 12. Second and 12 for Liberty-Eylau at the Carthage 25. Phillips with it now. Play action fake. He wants to throw it. Throwing it deep into the end zone. Man wide open. This ball is
dropped.
It's dropped.
He was wide open.
It is dropped. He was open in the end zone, the corner of the end zone, the far corner, and just flat dropped it.
Wow.
Yeah, Makai got caught looking in. The receiver beat him, but he was able to get back, and Risey made the catch at the back end zone line. He was able to knock it out of his hands.
Oh, he did knock it out of his hands?
Yes.
Okay, all right.
Good play on defense.
Third and 12 now for Liberty-Eylau. Third and 12 at the 25-yard line of Carthage. 7:08 to go in the ball game. Carthage leading at 28-14. Third and 12 for Liberty-Eylau. Snap back to Phillips. Phillips, play action fake. Pump fake left. Now going left into the end zone. This ball is incomplete.
Good
coverage back there by Nick Moore, and there's a flag that's going to come in.
Thought to me that it was offensive because he ran into our guy.
And our guy had the position, was going for the ball.
That's right.
Unless he's going to call holding on them.
They might have.
Holding against Carthage. Scott's a rat. Really upset at that call.
7:02 left. 28-14 Carthage.
All right, it's first down and 10 now for Liberty-Eylau. First and 10. Hand off the running back, hoof up the middle to the 15. He's down close to the goal line. He is into the end zone for a touchdown. 15-yard touchdown run for Liberty-Eylau.
Kept that. I believe that's who it was.
Sir?
I think the quarterback kept that.
Yeah, quarterback kept it, okay.
And they're going to go for two.
.56 to go. They're going for two. Here's Phillips running for his life over at the right. Now he's going to run for it, and he's not going to make it as he is pushed out of bounds at the 4-yard line. So the 2-point conversion, no good. Carthage leads it 28-20. 6:56 to play in the ball game. Kickoff coming up here in just a second.
The city of Carthage, county seat of Panola County, gas capital of the United States, and friendliest spot in the world. We have it all: temperate weather, lots of jobs, good schools and churches, and even the Texas Country Music Hall of Fame. Carthage, a great spot on Highway 59 to settle down or just to visit for a while. Panola College, local medical care, a low tax base, and great shopping. That's Carthage. Recommend us, refer us, and revive yourself in the piney woods of East Texas. Carthage, with places we're all proud to call home.
All right, well, the Bulldogs led at halftime here 20, let's see, at halftime it was 21-0. We had a turnover late in the first half that would have made it 28-0, scored early in the third to make it 28-0, and now three straight touchdowns for Liberty-Eylau, and it is 28-20. 6:56 to go in the ball game.
We still have a chance to win this ball game by keeping the ball in our hands.
The momentum, though, definitely in Liberty-Eylau's favor right now. Long kickoff. We take it back at the 10, to the 15, the 20. This is Colbert, 25, 30. Good return out to the 31-yard line. So decent field position for Carthage at the 31 with 6:50 to go in the contest.
Maybe time to ride our horse. You know, they've been rushing their linebackers quite a bit. If we ride our horse here, maybe we can run some time off this clock.
Well, I think we got a great spot there. I thought he went down to the 31, but it's at 33. We'll take it. First down and 10 for Carthage at the 33. Ball is on the right hash. All right, Kaysen Davis, the quarterback, is going to be under center. Keontae Ingram, the tailback. A wide out to each side. Handoff goes to Ingram. Ingram going left. 35 and pushed out of bounds over there in the Carthage bench after a gain up to the 35-yard line.
So that's where you go down in bounds. And he had a hole up the middle, and he cut it to the, he wanted to go to the outside.
Yeah, it's like a stretch play, and he had some room out here, but one of their Liberty-Eylau defenders showed great speed getting over there and cutting him off.
6:44 to go in the game. The clock stopped because he went out of bounds. Keontae Ingram going to split out as a receiver now. Empty backfield for Kason Davis. Two receivers to each side. Snap back to Davis. He wants to throw it. Throws it down the field for Keontae Ingram. Incomplete at midfield.
He had to get rid of it. He was rushed. He had to throw it early. 28-20. 6:39 left. The momentum is definitely in Liberty-Eylau's hands this half.
Now it's third down and eight. Carthage up by eight, 28-20, 6:39 to play.
We need a first down.
Boy, we need a first down in the worst sort of way. Snap back to Davis. Davis this time throws it to Callaway. Flag on the play. Callaway to the 40. Callaway to the 44. Has a first down, but holding. There is a flag.
I think it's going to be holding on us. It was out here in the open. Let's see what happens. Six and a half to play.
Pass interference against Carthage.
Well, that's what Sred said before, that he likes to, that Callaway likes to push off a little bit.
Yeah, just inopportune time penalties is just hurting us, getting us second and third and long. Kind of shooting ourselves in the foot here in the second half.
15-yard penalty. Boy, those offensive pass interference calls are really punitive. 15 yards, moves it back to the 20-yard line. Coach Surratt visiting with the referee. .634 left to go in the ball game. Carthage leading it by a score of 28-20, but the momentum has shifted big time to Liberty-Eylau here in the second half after Carthage led with 9:49 to play in the third quarter. They led it 28-0. Liberty-Eylau has scored three straight touchdowns, and our offense has sputtered here in the second half after that first drive of the third quarter.
We need to get it to the playmaker.
It is now third down and long.
Need at least a good gain.
Third and about 23. Davis in the shotgun. Snap back to him. Hands off on the draw to Keontae Ingram. 25, 30, 35, 40. Has a first down, 45, midfield, 45, and to the 43-yard line. First and 10 for the Bulldogs.
No hankies on the field either. That was a big-time play right there. He had a hole, though, a Mack truck could drive through. And then the speed he's got. He split two defenders and outrun those two. And finally was dragged down by the last man that could get him.
39-yard pickup for Keontae Ingram. And what a play that is. That is the play of the game right there so far.
That was a good call. They thought we were going to line up and throw it, and we ran it.
First and 10 for Carthage now at the Liberty-Eylau 41.
Clock.
Offset out of the left. Hand off to Keontae Ingram. 40, 35, 30. And he is pushed out of bounds after another Garrett's Record Service Bulldog first down. That's going to go from the 41 to inside the 30.
So he's crossed 100 now, hasn't he?
Yes. From the 41 to the 26, 15 more. 139 yards now for Ingram on the ground. 5:36 to go. Carthage first and 10 at the Liberty-Eylau 26 after about a 1 yard gain, make it 2 to the 24.
That's a good block there by Brewster, but another guy was right there ready to get him. Time is ticking. They have two timeouts, Liberty-Eylau. We've got three. We can gain, we can run the ball every time now. We do have a field goal kicker.
Second down and 8. This is the part of the game where you do want to run the play clock down. Mm-hmm. Want to snap it with about 5 seconds to go each time. Keep your eye on it there, Kason. He's looking straight at it. 4:58 to go in the ball game. 6 on the play clock. Snap with 4. Pitch out goes Ingram. Ingram left. Stopped. Loss. It's going to be a loss of about 1.
He's probably, Surratt was out there probably telling him, cut up field.
That's what he was saying.
Yeah, he just keeps wanting to go to the sidelines. A while ago when he ran his long run, he ran right up the middle. Did his plant foot, went right up the middle. 4:30 left.
Third down, 10 now. Third and 10 at the Liberty-Eylau 26. 4:23 to go in the ball game. Play clock at 11. 4:15 to go in the game. 5 seconds on the play clock. 3, 2. Snap with one. Davis looking to throw. Wants to go with a screen pass.
Drop.
Incomplete.
Yeah, I wondered. I was thinking about, do you run here and still have fourth down, you know? That way you let the clock run another 45 seconds off.
Yeah.
You know?
Uh-huh.
You run that one, then try fourth down.
I think that's that would have been a good call right there.
A field goal would put it away.
But a field goal from right here would be from the 33. It'd be a 43-yard effort.
That's a little bit much. Yeah. Potential of a bad snap, block. I think we're going to call a timeout.
Okay, right. Timeout call for Carthage. For all of your real estate needs, call Dustin Burns at Colwell Banker, Ken Anderson Associates. The phone number 903-754-3325. Again, for all of your real estate needs, call Dustin Burns, Colwell Banker, Ken Anderson Associate, 903-754-3325.
Are you experiencing sickness, fighting a toothache, or just need someone to vent your frustrations to? Stop by the Hope Project in downtown Tenaha for all your medical, dental, and mental health needs. They accept Medicaid, Medicare, and most major insurance plans and offer a sliding fee discount for those who qualify. The Hope Project is now a designated site to offer counseling assistance with the healthcare marketplace. For a healthier East Texas, come see the Hope Project or call 936-248-HOPE.
Well, we jumped out to 28 point lead, and now it's 28-20. We do have the ball in there into the field. The only good thing is that we cannot lose it on their next possession. The best they could do is tie it. But we need a first down.
Fourth down. Let's see. The timeouts, two for Liberty-Eylau, two for Carthage. Fourth down and 10 for Carthage at the Liberty-Eylau 26. Scott Surratt, a great play caller. Let's see what he dials up here. Fourth and 10 for Carthage at the Liberty-Eylau 26. Need to keep the drive going. Here's Davis, play action fake. He wants to throw it. Still looking, throwing deep into the end zone. This ball is tipped away, incomplete, and Liberty-Eylau will take over. That was intended for Keontae Ingram. They had pretty good coverage back there. Maybe a little bit underthrown. Liberty-Eylau will have it at their own 26, 3:56 to go.
Yeah, the good thing about it does take them a little bit longer to score than it does us because they rely on the run a lot more. But our defense needs to step up now and make a play.
Defense has gotten a little rest because of the length of that Carthage drive. Liberty-Eylau down by 8 points, 3:56 to go in the ball game. They have it at the Liberty-Eylau 26, Phillips with it now. Hands off to Florence, going to his right, and he's going to be stopped for a very short gain there.
3:46 and counting on the time clock. 28-20 Carthage.
That's a gain of one.
Needed a good play just like that again.
Second down and 9 now for Liberty-Eylau at their 27, 3:26 in counting. We'll keep you updated on the clock after every play. Phillips in the shotgun, snap back to him. Running back coming this time to his left. We've got pretty good coverage out there, very good. Nick Moore doesn't let him get outside, and it's a gain of only 2 to the 29.
That's
clock still
two.
Running.
It's a deal, too, where the running back should have just run on out of bounds.
And DeJulian did a good job as outside linebacker position to push it out there and keep his legs moving and good hold there by the corner on the outside as well.
2:54 to go. Third down at about 7. They throw to the left. It's caught there by Isaiah Cross, and he is pushed out of bounds to stop the clock at the 33. It's a gain of 4, and it's going to bring up fourth down.
Fourth down. It's a big play here. Fourth and about 4.
I may look for something a little trickery with a little reverse or end around for just 4 yards.
Are there veer?
Fourth down and four for Liberty-Eylau.
All right, defense, one play is all we need.
This is
don't let them get behind.
Pretty much the ball game right here. Fourth down and four for Liberty-Eylau at their 32. Phillips, snap back to Phillips. Phillips throwing to his right. He's caught it. They've got it at the 35. Now it's going to be short of the first down. He did not make it. He needed four, and he's going to get three on the play.
Mikhail Gates made that play all by himself. He jerked him around, and he fell backwards.
Carthage holds, and they get the football. Wow. Fourth and four for Liberty-Eylau, and they needed, again, 4 yards. They picked up three, and you said Gates is the one who made the play.
That's right. He's been cramping up, but he came back in. You know, he had to fill big shoes last year when Brown went down, and that was the best thing that ever happened to us. And Brent, now I'm not saying bad thing for Brown, but it was the best thing for McHale to learn how to play that middle linebacker position.
So now Carthage takes over at the Liberty-Eylau 35. Liberty-Eylau with two timeouts left, 2:42 to play in the game.
That time for Ingram to take this to the house.
Davis under center. Hand off to Ingram. Ingram to the 30. Ingram 25. Another Garrett's record service. Bulldog first down. Keontae Ingram for 11 yards.
Yeah, he's the workhorse here in this fourth quarter. He's the reason we're moving the sticks. Of course, you got to give it to the offensive line, too. I think we made some stupid mistakes here in this, with the penalties and that kept them in their drives, a couple of their drives. They have two timeouts left, but they've optioned not to take them.
Kaysen wisely letting the play clock run down. Now you want to get the play off. Four, three, two. Snap with one. Handoff goes to Keontae Ingram again up to the 20. 15, 10, 5. He's going to score. Touchdown run by Keontae Ingram. 24 yards for Ingram. This Bulldog touchdown is made possible by the Bulldog Stop, where you can find Exxon Gas plus the best snacks in town.
I tell you, if y'all don't come watch you play, you're missing out, because he is the real deal. That's a fast defense he's playing against, and he's like a good back. Later in the game, give him the ball, because
and he
gets lubricated up, and he wants the ball. Every running back wants it over and over and over. Go ahead, Dustin.
And, you know, like we like you said, Mark, he just did a good job of keeping the shoulder pads square and going forward, and he's able to keep his balance and get in the end zone.
Here's the United First United Methodist Church extra point. No good. We missed that one to the right. And so the score is 34-20. Carthage with 2:01 to play in the ball game. Back right after this.
Well, Larry, my computer's not acting right, so you may have to keep talking.
Carthage scoring with 2:01 to go in the fourth quarter. Keontae Ingram with a touchdown run. Ingram now with 174 yards on 20 carries. And the Bulldogs have got this one under control now, I believe.
This is Mark Harris at Farmers State Bank in Carthage. Did you know Farmers State Bank offers 15, 20, and 30-year fixed-rate mortgages? We will service your loan in-house, and you can make a payment at one of our five full-service locations, Center, Main Bank, and Rough Rider Branch, Carthage, Joaquin, Shelbyville. So come by Farmers State Bank, and let us help you buy the home of your dreams. Farmers State Bank, member FDIC, and equal housing lender. Money.
Well, these high school games are games of momentum, and we had it in the first half. We looked like we was going to run off and leave with this thing. And in the second half, they came back, scored three touchdowns to get within eight.
And I tell you what, I forgot to mention that the Dogs on that touchdown possession there again crossed the Bauer Furniture Company red zone, and they scored. They have scored on every time in the red zone tonight with one exception, and that was when we fumbled late in the first half. So Carthage will kick off now, 2:01 to go in the ball game. The Bulldogs leading at 34-20, and it appears we're going to kick it deep here. And it is a line drive, deep kick. It hits at the 8, inside the 5, goes into the end zone. They're going to run it out, coming to the left.
Big mistake.
And Nick Moore will not let him get loose, and that was a big mistake. As Mark said, he is down at the 1-yard line. Nick Moore, way to go, Nick.
Nick playing his outside.
He's kept his lane. He did not make the mistake of going inside, and he has dropped. They're going to spot him, I think, at the 3.
You know, our kickoff team has really done a good job tonight. All special teams other than the missed extra point right there, pushed it right. But, you know, other than, you know, this is our first full game, we didn't finish last week. We get to finish our scrimmage against Marshall. I think the team's holding up pretty good as far as conditioning, a few cramps here and there.
All right, they mark it at the 2. Snap back to Phillips. He's in the end zone. He throws from the end zone. It's caught out there at the 5, and he's going to be down at the 9-yard line, so that's going to be a gain on the pass play of 7 yards.
Greg Hurst on the tackle, senior.
Clock running. Liberty-Eylau quickly up to the line of scrimmage. Second down and 3. Phillips throws right. He's caught at the 15 to the 20. Out across the 25-yard line. It's going to be a first down. Going to go from the 9 to the 26. That's a gain of 17 on the pass play. And they're quickly to the line of scrimmage. 1:20 to go now. Snap back to Phillips. He throws right. This ball is caught. And it's going to be across the 30.
We like it when you catch them in bounds. Don't go out
That's
of bounds.
Right.
The clock's now at about a minute. Now they have a timeout by Liberty-Eylau. We'll be back after this.
All right.
Randy Hudson, a 1984 Carthage High School graduate, invites you to stop by their Carthage branch of the Hudson Financial Group. They offer property and casualty insurance on an individual platform, which allows them to help you with all types of risk. With companies like the Hartford, Mass Mutual, and Travelers, to just name a few, Randy and his dad, Herb, look forward to assisting you with your insurance and financial needs. The Hudson Financial Group, 1507 West Panola in Carthage, 903-693-7874.
Oh, her first word.
Mama.
Then, before I knew it.
Mom!
Soccer practice, art club, driver's ed, dating, graduation, 5 years off college. Mom, this is Ted. Wedding bells and suddenly.
Life fast forwards. Keep up with Texas Farm Bureau Insurance and protection that changes with your auto, home, and life needs. It's the right coverage for any moment. Because moment.
Okay, here's Phillips. Dropping back to pass. He's throwing deep. This ball is incomplete.
Good coverage. Well, the throw was not that good, and so the receiver had to turn and go a different direction. Our man had no hands on him. 101 left, 34-20 Carthage.
Third down and 2 for Liberty-Eylau at their 34. 61 seconds to go. Snap back to Phillips. He throws right. This ball is caught out there for a first down, short of the 40, and now he's down at the 40-yard line. That's going to be a gain of 6 yards on the pass play.
Well, next week we get White House to town, don't we, Larry?
That's correct. Dustin, under a minute to go now, 50 seconds to go. First and 10 at the 40. Here's Phillips dropping back. He wants to go with a screen over the middle to the 40, to the 45, out to the 50-yard line for what would be another first down, close to it at least.
Yeah, next week, White House at home, home opener for the Dogs this season, homecoming week.
It is a first down. Clock starts again, 35 seconds to go. Liberty-Eylau at midfield, throws left again. This ball is caught, keep him in bounds, and we do. I think they're out of timeouts. That's a note. They've used their last timeout, a gain of 7, and they will take their last timeout. We'll take a break.
Have an oil well, you need to get one. So Ricky and Casey Bagley at Bagley Well Services can help you take care of it. Bagley Well Services is a complete service. Hookups, pipelines, maintenance, backhoe, dozer, and pipe hauling. Bagley Well Service, one call does it all. 903-690-9700. 903-690-9700. Let Bagley Well Services do the work for you.
It's not Tex-Mex, it's Fresh Mex. That's the slogan at Don Juan's in Carthage. Don Juan's open at 10:30 Monday through Sunday and staying open late on Friday and Saturday for your dining convenience. Happy hour Monday through Friday, 2 until 7. Don Juan's, where $5 lunch specials are back. Don't forget, kids eat free with the purchase of an adult meal.
All right, here's Liberty-Eylau. Phillips throwing to the right, and it's incomplete.
22 seconds.
I thought they were out of timeouts, but that shows they still got two left. I don't think that's right for
that's
sure.
That's us. They showed one, but they don't have any left.
Oh, excuse me. That shows one, doesn't it? Okay, for them. I'm sorry. Shows two for us. Third down and three. Third and three for Liberty-Eylau at the Carthage 43. Snap back to Phillips. We got a three-man rush. He throws to the right. This ball is caught there for a first down. It's going to be a gain of seven on the pass play. First down for Liberty-Eylau. First and 10 at the Carthage 35. 15 seconds to go in the ball game. Snap back to Phillips. Phillips going deep. Going for the end zone. In the end zone, this ball is incomplete.
Good coverage. We had a man on front and behind back down there. Gatlin lost his helmet, so he's got to come out. 4.9 seconds left in the ball game. So this will be a throw in the end zone.
Yep, this will be it right here. So the Dogs are going to come home to face White House with a record of 1-0. Liberty-Eylau will be 0-2. And be sure and stay with us after the ball game. We'll not only have a recap of the scoring and the statistics, but we'll have an interview with Coach Surratt. Snap back to Phillips. This is going to be the final play of the game, most likely. Phillips, good protection. We only have three rushing. Phillips throwing deep into the end zone. A ball up in the air. Incomplete. That's the ball game. Carthage wins it by a score of 34-20. We'll be back with the stats right after this.
Need construction done? Check with Carlos and Shane Courtney at Courtney Construction Incorporated. They're the best in the business, whether it's pipeline or dirt work or field maintenance or general construction. The Courtneys are well experienced. Give them a call today at 903-694-2911 or stop by 1300 Northeast Loop in Carthage. Courtney Construction Incorporated. When you need it done right, call Courtney Construction. They'll get it done.
Fidelity Communications is ready to turbocharge your internet service with this amazing offer. You can get 125 megabit internet with 6 months of free Wi-Fi for just $79.99 per month for the first year. New Fidelity Communications customers get special pricing on all three different internet packages, ranging from 25 to 125 megabits per second, starting as low as $24.99 per month. Call 1-800-392-8070 or visit us online at fidelitycommunications.com.
The ladies at the Popcorn Place are ready to take care of your floral needs. They offer cut flower arrangements, memorials, and potted plants. If there is a special occasion in the future, such as a birthday or anniversary, or maybe just a special arrangement, let the ladies at the Popcorn Place assist you with your selection. And don't forget that they carry some wonderful gift items like crystal and pottery and have a bridal registry as well. This can all be found at the Popcorn Place on West Panola in Carthage, 903-693-5421.
Well, I'm Frances Hopkins Frazier, and I decided to go to Winkler Place because I was falling, and I was calling my son to come help me. So, therefore, I prayed about it, and Winkler Place came into my mind. God gave me the answer, and I'm in Winkler Place now, and I enjoy living there. I have everything I need. I'm happy at Winkler Place.
Okay, here's the wrap-up. No one wants to be involved in a fender bender, but if it happens to you, let Kelly's Collision Center make your car or truck look like new again. Located on Highway 59 North, that's Kelly's Collision Center. Now here are the statistics for the ball game. Friday night at Harris Field in Texarkana, Texas, two of the top 4A teams in the state got together, and the Carthage Bulldogs got off to a fast start, scoring on a 12-yard pass from Kaysen Davis to D. Bowen, 7-0 Dogs, 6:01 to play in the first. 8 seconds into the second quarter, another touchdown pass for Davis, this time 6 yards to Josh Gradberg, and the Dogs were up 14-0. The Dogs added to that lead with 4:35 to play until halftime. Another touchdown pass from Kaysen Davis, this time to D. Bowens. And at halftime, Carthage led 21-0. Carthage scored in the third quarter to take a 28-0 lead, this time a 66-yard pass from Kaysen Davis to Rod Calloway. And again, Carthage up 28-0, 9:49 to play in the third. But the Liberty-Eylau Leopards changed the momentum as they scored three straight times. And the first one was on a 14-yard touchdown pass. It was 28-6, 7:06 to play in the third. Then they scored on a one-yard run. It was 28-14 with 11:54 to go in the fourth. And then they scored on a 15-yard run, and they had cut the Carthage lead to 28-20 with 6:56 to play in the fourth quarter. But the Bulldogs came back and put the game away on a 24-yard run by Keontae Ingram, and Carthage wins it 34-20. Here's a look at the statistics. Carthage with 26 first downs, Liberty-Eylau 15. Carthage on the ground 158, Liberty-Eylau 137. Through the air, Carthage 23 of 32 for 289 yards. Liberty-Eylau 17 of 29 for 164 yards. One turnover in the ball game. That was a fumble by the Bulldogs late in the first half. Penalties, and there were many. Carthage had 11 for 114 yards. Liberty-Eylau 13 for 118 yards. Carthage punted once for 28 yards. Liberty-Eylau punted four times for a 41-yard average. Carthage is now 1-0 as they go to Bulldog Stadium next week for their home opener against the White House Wildcats. And Liberty-Eylau now is 0-2. Once again, your final score Friday night from Harris Field in Texarkana, Texas, the Carthage Bulldogs 34 and the Liberty-Eylau Leopards 20. For your Sports Beat station, I'm Larry Allen. All right. We're going to take the interview from Coach Surratt here in just a second. He has now finished talking to the team. And, Dustin, anytime you're ready, we're ready.
Don't forget, we have a scoreboard show later on. Listen to KGAS.
Coach, you talked in this game about the size of Liberty Island athletes. How do you think the Dogs met up with them tonight?
We played very well, first half especially. And we made some mistakes. You know, we should have had 28 on the board or at least 24. You know, we fumbled down there going in, and it was off the handoff exchange, and that's unexcusable. And but other than that, we played a clean first half. And the second half, Rod made the big play for us to get us going, and then and then we got down again and made just a couple of stupid penalties. You can't make bad. You can't have big penalties in a game. We were down there going again. I think it was around the 20, 25 going in, and big play, and then we got two penalties. You know, a 15-yarder and a 10-yarder, and backed us up. But overall, we're gonna make mistakes early for sure. We just got to cut the stupid mistakes out and just keep playing hard. We're gonna play hard and just keep battling and being physical. I thought we was physical again, and that's very important. How physical they were unbelievably physical, and I thought we matched their physicality, and maybe was even more physical than those guys.
Congratulations on the win. We'll see you next week at home for homecoming, home opener against White House.
Thank you.
You bet.
The Carthage Bulldogs win it here by a score of 34-20. Bulldogs with a 28-0 lead early in the third quarter. Then Liberty-Eylau came back to make it 28-20. But the Bulldogs score late to win it by two touchdowns. Once again, the Bulldogs will be at home next weekend. It's homecoming next week at Bulldog Stadium. We hope you can come out and support the Bulldogs as they go up against the Class 5A Wildcats from White House. But if you can't, we'll have it for you live here on KGAS starting at 7 o'clock as we look at the starting lineups.
And don't forget to listen to the scoreboard show on 104.3 in Carthage.
And so we're going to wrap it up here for Mark Harris. For Dustin Burns, I'm Larry Allen. For the rest of your KGAS sports crew from Harris Field in Texarkana, Texas, wishing you a great weekend. So long, everybody.